And Fitzhill, one of five African-American head men. And, of course, everyone knows Mike Price, who has certainly revitalized this UTEP football program. Miners saw the Spartans win the toss. San Jose State elects to defer its choice until the second half, so UTEP will get the football. Miners will be driving to the northern goal, the Spartans to the southern goal, to our right here at Spartan Stadium in this first quarter. It's great to have you along on UTEP Miner Game Day, wherever you are around the Miners radio or television network. It's Johnny Lee Higgins, number 21, and Howard Jackson, number 4, dropping deep for UTEP. The crowd, well, they're averaging about 7,000 a game here at 28,800-seat Spartan Stadium here in San Jose, and it's no secret that the future of this San Jose State program is somewhat in doubt, unfortunately so. The Spartans in all blue with white numerals trimmed in gold. The Miners in their white jerseys with blue pants, blue numerals, orange helmets with the orange stripe down the side of the uniform.
You know, they're going to be lucky if they get 5,000 a day, John. The fans just not supporting them out here. Beautiful, beautiful day.
Jeff Carr to kick off. We're underway from San Jose. The kick is headed to Johnny Lee Higgins, who fields it about 3 yards deep. He'll bring it out, crosses the 15, and is not going to get to the 20-yard line. The Miners will start inside the 20-yard line. Matt Castello, a freshman linebacker on special teams, getting upfield to make the play on Johnny Lee Higgins. They'll spot it close to the 17-yard line. And Jordan Palmer, second only to Timmy Chang in the WAC. And, of course, Chang had his problems last night in touchdown passes. Chang has 15, Palmer with 12. 9 of those coming in the last two games. He's really grown up as the season has progressed.
Absolutely. And I think you're going to see a bunch of stunts from the San Jose club at Jordan.
Double tight end set. Jackson, the lone setback. Stretch play. It's Jackson coming right. He crosses the 15-yard line and is cut down for a loss back at the 16. It's House, Garcia, Morris, Graniello, and Espinosa up front for the Miners. And as far as the skill players are concerned, Francis, Johnny Lee Higgins, Chris Morrow is out back in El Paso with an injury, so we'll pick up the receiver later. Jonas Kraft's at tight end and Howard Jackson in the backfield. We'll call it second and 11 from the 16-yard line. Chris Francis comes out to the left, to the right side. Johnny Lee Higgins, it's a wing right set, and Jake Sears, a second tight end, comes in motion. Off the play fake, it's a bootleg right. Palmer fires up the side. It's caught by Kraft. First down across the 30, and Jonas Kraft is escorted out of bounds after a 24-yard gain at the 40-yard line. Beautiful play on the bootleg. First down Miners as McNamara, Ransom, Green, and Ficklin are up front for San Jose State. Cox and Staples, the WAC leading tackler, Staples, the linebackers. Hardy and George on the corners. Nunez, Powell, and Godinez as the three safeties. First and 10 Miners at their own 40.
Just a bootleg last time, John, and came out, and they had it pretty well covered, but Palmer threaded the needle.
Jackson, the lone setback. Two receivers left, one to the right side. Jordan may be changing the play, we'll see. Palmer, three-step drop, the hitch left is caught at the 40, 45, and getting close to midfield. It looked like Aaron Gibbons, the junior, with his first catch, and it should be a first down just across midfield on the near sideline. Jarrell Hardy and Josh Powell in the coverage, with the Miners getting the ball on the flanks, and Aaron Gibbons did the rest.
Just a bubble screen, as you can see right there. Good blocking by the receivers up front, but that is a play that's going to keep San Jose from bunching up and coming in and blitzing them.
Miners have had more than 40 more first downs than their opponents thus far this year. Twin receivers this time to the right. Palmer hands to Jackson, coming left, got some room, 45-40, and taken out of bounds with another first down on the near sideline at the San Jose State 39-yard line by Brian Nunez, one of the safeties, number 15. Howard Jackson looks quick this afternoon.
There's a stretch right there, and Jackson hit that corner out there. Nice job of the offensive line, and the linebacker just couldn't catch up with him. Again, ground level, you can see him coming around there. That is just a ton of speed, John.
Miners look a lot quicker at the outset than they did on that soggy track a week ago in Ruston, Louisiana. Twins to each side from the Spartan 39-yard line. Palmer backpedals to throw, has some time, steps up, taking a shot to the end zone. Francis is out there. Francis has it inside the 5-yard line. He went up over the defender, shielded the defender from the football, made a remarkable catch. It'll be first and goal from the 1. He beat Treston George on the play. 38-yard pass play.
Well, there's a difference right there, John. Treston George, 5'9". France is 6'1". He went up and used that size, went up and got it. You can see right there, screened him off. Good concentration.
Francis with a catch in his 29th consecutive game. Triple I in the backfield. They give it away right side. Shamwise into the end zone. Coming right side. Touchdown, Miners. And UTEP is on the board first, scoring first for a seventh consecutive game.
You're looking at a confident club out here, John. They took that ball all the way down from the, 16-yard line all the way down into the end zone and did it precision. I tell you, just like a surgeon out there. Nice job.
Aaron King to snap, Bryce Benicos to hold, and Reagan Schneider to try the extra point. Ball is down, the kick is on its way, and the kick is good, and the Miners strike first again this afternoon, an 83-yard drive to start the game here in San Jose. So UTEP leading 7-0 as Josh Shamwise scores the touchdown out of that triple I. The Miners getting up to the line of scrimmage, snapping it in a hurry.
Yeah, Shamwise comes in there, ran up somebody's back. If he'd cut back in, he probably could have gone and stand up. But that puts a lot of pressure on a point of attack at triple I.
For Josh Shamwise, his third rushing touchdown of the year, and a 7-0 start for UTEP. It's uncanny how well the Miners have done right at the start of games, and it shows you how well they have been prepared by this coaching staff.
Well, I tell you what, John, it's just amazing. Palmer took that club, moved that club right down the field in big chunks, and then Francis makes that great catch.
So the Miners will kick off, leading 7-0, trying for their fifth consecutive victory as Raymond Schneider tees the football up. Miners scoring on their first possession for a fourth time in the games as well this year. Seven straight games scoring first for the Miners. Schneider approaching the football. Twin safeties in San Jose State, and a high kick is headed to the near side, taken across the 5-yard line by Preston George. He comes left, crosses the 20. Now he's got some room. He's at the 30, the 35, and taken out of bounds by Philip Moss at the 40-yard line. They had a left return on. And that's one of the few good returns we've seen from the opponents in the last several weeks. A 34-yard return by Preston George. Spartans, one of the top kick-returning teams in the country, and they showed why right there.
George brought that ball up the middle, then broke to his left, got a seam in there, and then that's what you don't want him to do.
Dale Rogers, 13th nationally in pass efficiency, completing, as you can see, well over 50% of his passes, only 4 interceptions, 9 touchdowns. 3 receivers in the pattern, and Rogers changes the play. Twin receivers right, 1 to the left side. Rogers fades inside the 35. The screen right caught by Thompson at the 40. Trying to find running room, he can't because Robert Rodriguez was right there to shadow him. And Rodriguez makes the play. Obeng, Lorette, Cantoon, Novella, and Staples up front for San Jose State. Skiller, Jones, and Broussard, the wide receivers, with Wagey at tight end and Thompson at tailback. We'll call it a gain of a yard. It'll be second down and 9 yards to go.
Miner showed blitz in there. Rogers changed the play, checked off to a screen in there, and then Miner's backed out of the blitz. Nice job.
Thompson alone set back. Twins to the left, another receiver right on 2nd and 9. And again, Rogers might be changing the play. Rogers has the snap, deep drop to throw, rushes on, he flips it over the middle of the field, and slipping is the intended receiver at the Miner 45-yard line, and that would be James Jones. James Jones, the intended receiver. Gibbons, Minio, Zach West, and Ebach up front for the Miners. Rodriguez, Acanduro, and Howard, the outstanding trio at linebacker. Ward and Fenner on the corners. Fleskoski and Dowdy are the safeties. Quentin Demps is back in El Paso. He's got a hamstring problem. And the outstanding redshirt freshman should be back in uniform with Miners next at the field in 2 weeks at home against Rice. 3rd down and 9. Rodgers out of the shotgun. Snapped a little bit high. He handles it. Back to throw. Fires right. It's going to be caught across midfield. John Broussard coming back with Adrian Ward in coverage. And he picks up 11 yards. And a Spartans first down just across midfield at the UTEP 48-yard line. Good throw by Rogers and a good comeback by Broussard.
Yeah, but a lot of time to throw in there, John. Again, that field, we walked down on it prior to the game, and it's wet. And they're not getting a good rush on him. He can't stand back there 6 seconds.
This time they go with an up back. It's James T. Callier in front of Thompson. They toss it back to Thompson, coming left, cuts it in. He's at the 45, and as he tries to cut, he slips and goes down at the 43-yard line, but he gains 5 on the play. Alex Obamese, number 47, finally cut it down. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go.
Well, it's basically a two-back set. You've got just a toss pitch in here. Thompson, good back, got good speed and good balance.
Looked like Ebach was being held on the play as Thompson went by. The Spartans, a season-high 315 yards rushing last week at Hawaii. Less than 200 the 2 weeks before. They give it away to Thompson again, and he runs right into Chris Minio at the line of scrimmage, falls forward, and basically it's no gain for Tyson Thompson. And again, the Spartan players are the ones slipping in the early going.
That just a base handoff up front, as you can see, you had a lead coming in, even the lead blocker slipped. Then Thompson slipped,
and Minio slipped.
So no footing out there.
Third down and 5 for the Spartans. Miners almost jump offside, but Zach West gets back onside. Rogers pulled away to audibilize. On 3rd and 5, twins to each side. The senior quarterback turns, hands to Thompson straight ahead. First down as they crossed up the Miners. Thompson gets all the way to the 37-yard line. He needed 5. He got about 6.5 before Thomas Howard brought him down. An obvious passing situation, and Rogers checked to this play.
Anytime that you have a good back like that, 99% of them is going to break on the green back there. So you got to slow the backside linebackers down and fill that hole.
Spartans down 7-0, marching inside the Miners' 40-yard line after the good kickoff return by Preston George. Rogers in the controls, and again he's changing the play. Twins to the right, another receiver left. Miners showing blitz, and here they come. Rogers slips, fires right, and misses. Rufus Skiller, number 80, cutting to the inside the 30-yard line. The Spartan players having a heck of a time with their footing, and that time it affected Rogers.
Rogers, a big kid, you know, he's about 6'3", 230 pounds. He's got a lot of weight in there to put that plant foot down, but it slipped right out from underneath of him. They cannot keep their footing out there.
Second and 10 for San Jose State, Miner 37. And we've got movement. Osmar Staples, number 73, the right offensive tackle, pulled out of his three-point stance well before the snap of the football.
Prior to the snap, 73, offense, false start, 5-yard penalty, the down is still 2.
Rich Colon is our Western Athletic Conference referee. Robert Baker, Bill Scott, John Irabaran, Bill Baraya, Robert Abels, and Mike Angelus are working with Colon this afternoon. 7-0 Miners, just over 10 minutes left to play in the first quarter. Miners marching 83 yards on their first drive from scrimmage. First and 15 now from the 42-yard line. Rogers pulls back the throw, plenty of time. Now the shovel pass to Thompson. He's wrapped up back at the 45-yard line. Who was that that stayed home?
That's was that Minio?
Was that Rodriguez or was that Minio or was it Joe Ward? Somebody did a great job staying home and disrupting the play.
The way they're patting each other on the head out there was either Zach West or Minio. Let's take a look here on the replay. Again, it was a late shuffle pass coming in there. It was set up in there. There it is right there, the shuffle, and it was
Minio, I believe.
Yes, it was.
Chris Minio. So the loss back to the 45. Now Rogers will throw on second and third and long. He's taking a shot up the middle of the field. He's got a man out there. It's just overthrown. Just overthrown inside the 5-yard line. John Broussard, the intended receiver, and he had some room. Adrian Ward closing on the football, but it was just overthrown, and it'll be fourth down.
You know, on that long pass, John, this wet type of a slippery feel in there, the receiver's got the advantage. He made the cut. The corner just about slipped, went in there, but he had him beat. If that pass would have been half a foot shorter, he'd had a touchdown for them.
Waylon Prather is 8th in the WAC, averaging 38 yards a kick. Jamal Fenner is in the top 20 nationally in punt return, standing at his own 10-yard line. Prather will try and get it out of bounds, I'm sure. Kick end over end. Fenner lets it go. It hits at the 10, takes a lateral bounce, fortunately for the Spartans, and goes out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. A fortunate boot by Waylon Prather, and that's where the Miners will begin. 7-0 UTEP with 9:21 left first quarter. Back to San Jose with game day after this.
Fox Toyota is backing the UTEP team with a season-long tailgate party. Roy Fox Toyota is opening huge holes in truck and SUV prices. You'll score with big rebates and discounts because we're passing all the savings on to you. Save $6,000 on Tundras, $4,000 on 4Runners, $3,000 on Highlanders, and $3,000 on Tacomas. Catch the year's best deal now at El Paso's number one, Roy Fox Toyota.
Renewable sources of electricity like wind and solar power increase energy options and help conserve natural resources. El Paso Electric's new wind turbines produce electricity without using water or fossil fuels. And EPE's commitment to conservation includes more, like giving a solar electric system to the school district planetarium. At EPE, we believe making smart investments in renewable energy and education today will yield great returns in the future.
For worry-free air conditioning and heating, Gray Air Conditioning has been serving the El Paso and Las Cruces area with professional service and installation for over 25 years. Gray Air Conditioning offers 24-hour service and emergency service 7 days a week. Certified technicians provide maintenance and installation on all makes and models, such as Mastercool, Trane, and Lennox. Call the professionals for a free estimate at 544-1566.
Miners' next home game coming up 2 weeks from tonight after next week's open date, 7:05, Saturday, November 13th. The Rice Owls, led by head coach Kenny Hatfield, will be in the Sun Bowl. Plenty of great seats on sale at the UTEP Ticket Center and all Ticketmaster outlets. First 15,000 will get an autographed Miners team photo. Miners starting inside the 10. Palmer, the hips left, caught by Gibbons at the 5, the 10, and Gibbons taken down hard by Josh Powell up near the 15-yard line, but nonetheless, it's a gain of about 7 and a good gain on first down. It'll be second down and 3 yards to go. Good play.
There's your bubble screen again, and again, that's going to slow the rush down in here. Good block up front, but a great open field tackle right here.
Second down and 3 yards to go. Miners twice have started inside their own 20, but marched 83 yards following the opening kickoff. Out of the shotgun, Matt Austin in the backfield to the right of Palmer. Snap is back. They give it away to Austin. Straight ahead. He spins and should have the first down as he gets up to the 19-yard line. So they tried to spread it out of the shotgun. And Palmer handed it to Matt Austin, the former Parkland Matador, and he has a minor first down up at the 19-yard line.
Yeah, and you got a stunt that time from Ezekiel Staples coming in, but Austin, you know, 30 pounds heavier than Jackson, so he's got a little bit more footing out there.
This time the Miners will go with an empty backfield, 5 receivers, 2 to the left side, 3 to the right side, Palmer under center. Palmer fades to throw. Steps, delivers left, caught by Moore at the 25. Right about there. It'll be a good game, about 5 yards on first down. Miners will take it. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go for UTEP. Keith Burns, the former Tulsa head coach, now the defensive coordinator here at San Jose State.
He had 5 wides there, an empty backfield in there. And again, there was a short possession passing game on his slippery field and is working for him.
Miners looking like a well-oiled machine offensively, getting better every week. Double tight end set, Jackson is returned, receivers right and left. San Jose State shows blitz. Palmer turns, hands to Jackson, and now whistles and flags stop play.
Somebody on the right side moved out of there because one of the defensive players pointed to him immediately. That's a shame.
Rich Poland will tell us.
Prior to the snap, false start, 37 offense. 5-yard penalty, the down is filtered.
Actually, Jake Sears, the Miners, 20th in terms of fewest penalties per game in the NCAA, and it was Jake Sears on in the far left of your screen, actually, on the right, just rocked back. That's all it takes. And also the right guard, it looked like. Benji Graniello also rocked a little bit. So it'll be second down and 9, Miners at their own 21-yard line. Jackson comes in motion left out of the backfield. Palmer flips it to Jackson across the 25, and he steps out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Gain of about 6. So it'll leave the Miners with 3rd and 3 coming up. And Miners on third down this year, 37% conversion, eighth best in the WAC.
Bringing him out in motion to his left and just threw a short pass to him. He got it, trying to get him some running room, a nice safe pass.
Higgins comes out to the left side, twin receivers to the right side. On third down and three, Palmer hands to Jackson, coming left, trying to find running room, cuts it back, first down and more, 40, near side of midfield, the 40, he might go! Jackson is tripped up from behind at the 30 at the 27-yard line of the San Jose State Spartans. Jarrell Hardy saved the touchdown. Howard Jackson, 46 yards on third down and three, making a nice cut back to the inside.
Basically your counter trey play, and the kid saw it, broke back inside, and he's got that great speed. I was surprised with a last ditch leap in there, they tackled him by an ankle.
So the Miners in Spartans territory again, a first down at the 29-yard line. Ball in the near hash, three receivers in the pattern. Jackson stays in the game. Palmer turns, hands to Jackson coming left. 30, 25, good gain on first down. Jackson all the way to the 23-yard line. Miners having great success early on first down this afternoon.
You know, we're taking a look at this. You know, what they're trying to do and what they have done, they've done a great job of scouting this club, is that they like to load up and they like to blitz you from one side or the other. They saw that, they ran away from it, got a good 6 yards out of it.
Second down, 4 yards to go. Two receivers right, one to the left. Jackson behind Palmer on second and four. Palmer appears to be changing the play. And Jackson now moves to a wing left. So Palmer to throw as they blitz, fires across the middle. It's caught inside the 10. Jason Boyd into the end zone. Touchdown, Miners! What a great change by Jordan Palmer, and he found a streaking Jason Boyd cutting in all alone at the 10-yard line, and he goes in standing up. It's a 29-yard touchdown pass, make it 23, and the Miners are on the board again.
Well, that's definitely a check, John. I mean, they were going to blitz. He looked up. He checked. They went out, and then the skinny post came in here, and we'll see it in a minute, but skinny post came in here, hit him right on the money.
And Snyder adds the extra point, and the Miners are up 14-0 here in San Jose. With 6:19 left to play, still first quarter, 14-0 Miners, Miner game day. We'll be right back to Spartan Stadium in San Jose.
Great deals and a huge selection. We've got it all at Sunland Park Pontiac Buick GMC. The 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix GT1 leads the pack in power, handling, and affordability. Only $245 a month. Or test drive the 2004 GMC Yukon XL. Rated by J.D. Powers as the most dependable full-size SUV. Only $467 a month.
Great service, great prices, great selection. At Sunland Park Pontiac Buick GMC. Sunland Park makes it fun
again. How about some jeans? Get them on, Cowtown Blue, get them on.
How about some boots? Like our black bullhide western boot, only $49.95. And our newest boot, all leather alligator prints, only $99.99.
Cowtown boots, get them on.
If a lunar rover can get out of a ditch on the moon, if a tugboat can tow an enormous freighter, if an M1 tank can have a heavy-duty Allison transmission, then why can't your truck? At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Sierra line of pickups. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
Now, here's your play on the last touchdown in here. Jordan Palmer's looking. He is checked off. He hits a skinny post out there right on the money. The quarterback not even close, touchdown. Great checkoff.
Miners with a lengthy march again. They went 83 yards on their first drive. This 92 yards, 7 plays, 3 minutes, 2 seconds. Palmer's 13th touchdown pass of the season. The second to Jason Boyd, and the Miners are up 14-0. What more can you have asked for here this afternoon in San Jose? as Reagan Schneider gets set to kick off. And this one, a very high short kick, a fair catch is called for, and it's taken. But then they start forward with it. That's got to be a flag, doesn't it? Well, actually, it was not the player that called for the fair catch. Anyhow, the Spartans will have it at about their own 33-yard line. As Donald Richardson, a reserve safety, he was not the one calling for the fair catch, but he handled the ball.
Yeah, but once the fair catch is called out there, John, another player can't come in there and receive the ball and run.
Then that should be a penalty, and they're talking, Rich Colin is, with a couple of his colleagues across the way, so there should be a flag. There was a fair catch signal made.
Mike Price is not happy about that, and he should be.
There was a fair catch signal clearly made. We saw it clear as day up here. But Rich Colin says no, so the Spartans will start at their own 33. Mike Price a little bit hot. Miners already with 180 total yards. Spartans got into Miner territory the first time, but then the drive stalled. I backfield behind Rogers, receivers right and left. Rogers turns, tosses to Thompson straight ahead. Now coming right, 35, 40, 45. And Adrian Ward throws him down, but not before Thompson has 17 yards and a first down at midfield. So Thompson having some success in the early going.
Toss sweep to the right in there, and Thompson's a big old strong kid, but they hit a seam, point of attack, off tackle. You'll see it here, they hit the seam, there you go. Nobody's pulling out, they're sealing off inside. There's your off tackle hole, and Thompson takes it.
First and 10 at midfield for San Jose State. They've got twins to the left, another receiver right, and again, Rogers is audibilizing. We've seen a lot of that early. Tight end Wagey is to the right. Rogers backpedals to throw, has time, delivers deep over the middle, and it's incomplete. And James Jones, the intended receiver, crossing from left to right inside the Miners' 40-yard line, but Rogers missed him. It'll be second down and 10 yards to go. 14-0 Miners with 5:44 left to play in the first quarter from Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. Good contingent. We'll try and get them on camera a little bit later on. Of Miner fans clad in orange and blue across the way.
Quite a few of them.
Yes, sir.
Miner's trying to get the pressure with the four up front, and again, that ground's kind of wet out there, and they're not getting as much as they want.
Second and 10 from midfield, I backfield. Rogers on the draw play gets to Thompson. 50, trying to get outside. 45, breaks a tackle to 40, first down. And as 15 yards goes out of bounds across the way at the 37-yard line. Godwin Akinduro trying to grab for Thompson, but that's generally not going to get the job done. And Thompson has another first down on the draw.
Taking a two-back set there, and he comes up, breaks to his left again. And as John said, Akinduro got too much speed. You got to get your legs up under you to bring a kid down 210 pounds with that kind of speed.
So San Jose State having some success running the football. Yeah. And no doubt Tim Hundley will have to make some changes. Looks like the Spartans have taken a timeout as they were a little bit undecided as to what they wanted to do offensively with the next play. So San Jose State using the first of its three available timeouts as the Miners seek their fifth consecutive victory this afternoon here in San Jose. This season has been, Bernie, very much on a parallel with the 2000 WAC championship season, because the Miners that year also lost their first and third games and had a lengthy winning streak. Don't forget, on the bottom of your screen, Men's and Women's Memorial Gym Madness. That's next Saturday, no football game. Festivities start at 5. The doors at Memorial Gym open at 6 as we preview the UTEP men's and women's basketball teams. First 1,000 fans will get an orange and blue Miner t-shirt. We'll have a dunk contest and a three-point shot contest. Autographs and games and rides for the kids. And, of course, tomorrow at University Field, it's UTEP soccer. The Miners, the winner yesterday over Boise State, will host Nevada at 1 o'clock and on Halloween. Costume contest for the kids. Candy will be given away. I hope to see you at University Field next week. Volleyball next home on November 11th at 7 o'clock in WAC play against Louisiana Tech.
As you said earlier, Tim Hundley right now can't be happy with what's happening with San Jose State establishing that ground game up there, and I'm sure you're going to see an adjustment here pretty quick.
First down at the Miners' 37-yard line. Twins to the right, another receiver left. Rogers with Thompson this time is the lone setback. On the draw, they give it away to Thompson, coming right, and Chris Minio wraps him up for a loss back at the 41-yard line. That time, the junior from Odessa Permian got through quickly, Minio, and dumped Tyson Thompson. There would be no cutback. Loss of four. It'll be second and 14.
That's good penetration by Minio right there. You can see he got his big paws out there, and Thompson good to get away from him. Loss of three.
14-0 Miners, first quarter here in San Jose. Second down at 14 yards to go. Again, twin receivers right. John Broussard, the lone receiver to the left. Thompson in the backfield. Behind quarterback Dale Rogers. Rogers off the play fake, bootleg left. Now looks back right, got all day, firing toward the corner, and it's caught. Inbounds, the catch is made by Rufus Stiller, and he beat Adrian Ward on the play. Inside the 10 at about the 9-yard line. Good throw by Rogers, but again, as you pointed out before, way too much time for Rogers to stand back there and make the throw. 32 yards.
Bootleg action, came back out and rolled back on him. That's tough. You ran the receiver ran a post corner out there, and Ward, I think he slipped just a little bit, but he got beat on.
Ward was right there. He just didn't make the play, and he might have slipped. You're right. First and goal at the 9, our backfield. Spartans driving to the southern goal. They toss it back to Thompson. He cuts it to the inside. Is it the 5? Is it the goal line? And he scores. Tyson Thompson has the Spartans on the board, and San Jose State is right back in the game.
That's way too easy there, John. Way too easy. You get that lead back out there. Just that that short toss in there, and you got your lead back that cuts that linebacker off, Rodriguez, and you've got to tackle this kid. This kid's not going to go down with a finger.
So the Spartans march 67 yards to get on the board for the first time. And now Jeff Carr has made 33 in a row. The school record is 36 to try the extra point. Kick is on the way, and the kick is good. So San Jose State's down 14 early has an answer. And we've got a timeout on the field with 4:43 left first quarter. Miner lead is now 7 back to San Jose after this.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Casa Nissan, and we're going long with big savings. Tackle a Titan King Cat for just $19,998. Or go for two in an 05 Ultimate. It's just $18,998. Even better, just for taking a test drive, you'll get two tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. The clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Which high-definition big screen is right for you? CRT, DLP, flat panel, or LCD? It can be confusing, but at Pat Goff Supply and TV Warehouse, our personalized red carpet service make buying a new Toshiba high-definition big screen easy. Plus, on all Toshiba high-definition big screens, including the exclusive cinema series, you pay nothing till 2006. Pat Goff Supply and TV Warehouse in Las Cruces and in El Paso, where we'll deliver your new Toshiba high-definition big screen in 5 hours, guaranteed.
Travis Crawford says, move them out now. Travis Crawford, Buick, GMC, Pontiac, Suzuki, Subaru, and Saab announces El Paso's sale of the year. The 04 Clearance Countdown. For 4 days only, a special factory allocation of 300 new 2004 cars and trucks are priced to move. 4 days and 300 fantastic new cars and trucks. 0% financing on most models. Travis Crawford, Buick, GMC, Pontiac, Suzuki, Subaru, and Saab. Montana at Airway. The 04 Clearance Countdown. Let's do it now.
Hope to see you at Pepsi Minor Town prior to the Miners' next home game, which will be 2 weeks from tonight in the Sun Bowl against the Rice Owls. It's located on the Baltimore Street practice field north of the Sun Bowl. Festivities get underway about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. For more information about Pepsi Minor Town, or if you'd like to be a part of it, 747-6229. Miners have cut the or have seen their lead cut in half as we get set for the kickoff by Jeff Carr. Again, Jackson and Higgins standing inside the 5-yard line. And Carr's kick is on its way. Higgins will have to field it about 6 yards deep, and he will kneel it down. Wisely so. The Miners will have their best field position to date, although they've scored in two of two possessions. They'll start at their own 20. 67 yards, rather, in six plays, a minute 36 seconds. Tyson Thompson with his fifth rushing touchdown of the year, a nine-yard run. That was a big score for San Jose State.
Yeah, they need to come down and control that ball and keep that offense of UTEP's off the field. But Huntley right now is making some adjustments out there to slow that ground game down a little bit. Much too easy.
Almer's been perfect thus far, 7 of 7, 116 yards and a touchdown. Jackson in the backfield. Palmer gives to Jackson. Coming left, trying to cut, and can't do it. He's going to be taken down, maybe for a loss. Back at the 19-yard line. They got penetration, and then Jackson tried to cut it back and slipped and went down. So it'll be second down and 11. Jamonte Cox and Ezekiel Staples, the two line, Ezekiel Staples.
Stretched to the left in there, and San Jose State did a job that time, John, just staying base.
Second down and long. Miners have been very good on first down thus far. Twins to each side. Palmer under center, Bo Morris, long snap count. And Jordan on the draw, gives it away to Jackson, right side. Trying to find running room, trying to find the corner. Cuts it back at the 20, 25, nice job. Howard's all the way up near the 28-yard line. Wasn't much there, and Howard Jackson somehow got about 9 yards on the play. And it'll leave the Miners with third down and two from their own 28.
Normally this kid's just a draw right here. He couldn't find his hole up the middle, so he breaks out. Normally he likes to find a hole and take off. But you can see they did a nice job of sending him off, so he was dancing around trying to find what he had.
Miners have converted on their only prior try on third down. This is third and two. Palmer hands to Jackson. They got penetration. Jackson's going to go down for a loss. Way too much penetration that time. Miners just overpowered up front. It'll be fourth down. Sean McNamara, only 206 pounds. And Sean McNamara got into the backfield.
Well, I'll tell you what, they got beat up last time on that long drive, that 92-yard drive going down there, and I think Burns, the defensive coordinator for San Jose, is saying, okay, we're going to penetrate a little more and try to get some penetration in there, and that's exactly what they did to stop Jackson.
Bryce Benikos, his first punt of the afternoon, ninth nationally, 44.5 yards per kick. Benikos leads all active players nationally in punts, career-wise, and yardage. The senior from Southern California, James Jones, standing back across his own 30-yard line. Snap is right on target, no pressure. Benikos with not a very good kick off the side of his foot. It takes a minor bounce inside the 35 and the 30, and this will turn out just fine. It was not a very good kick, but it rolls dead at the 27-yard line. And that winds up to be about a 45, 46 yards officially on the kick for Bryce Benikos. Also, when you attend the Miners' next home game, you can look for the El Paso Times Southwest Dairy Farmers Fun Zone. It opens when the gates do at 5:30 on the East Concourse of the Sun Bowl Stadium. Fun and games for kids of all ages. The El Paso Times Southwest Dairy Farmers Fun Zone. Trailing 14-7, the Spartans start at their own 27. Collier comes in motion left. Stretch play, it's Thompson, cuts it back, slips and goes down, trying to make a cut. Zach West was there, but again, very soft turf. We noticed that walking down on the field prior to the game. It's very choppy as well. It'll be second down.
Let's just show you right here. Now, you got a kid 210 pounds right here, and he's trying to make a cut, and both feet go out from underneath of him, right down his knee.
It's like he's on the ice over at the San Jose Pavilion, where they play hockey with the San Jose Sharks, who, of course, like the rest of the NHL, are on strike right now, are being locked out, actually. Second down from the 24-yard line. Dale Rogers backpedals, fires over the middle of the field, and it's dropped right through the hands of James Jones at the 40-yard line. Well-thrown ball by Rogers. It would have been a first down, and Jones might have heard footsteps.
Rogers goes inside. Akinduro gets his hands on that ball. Just gets his fingertips on it. Probably blocked Jones out. He couldn't make the catch.
So the Spartans will be looking at 3rd and 13 from their own 24-yard line. San Jose State on 3rd down, next to last in the WAC, 28% of the time converting on 3rd down. Rodgers out of the shotgun, Miner showing blitz. Now they come. Rodgers to throw, steps to his left and underthrows it. And he was hit by Justin Honnell just as he threw the ball. It'll be 4th down. So the Spartans will be forced to punt it away. 3 plays and out that time for the Miners defensively.
Well, you take a rush like they did. There was about 7 coming in there, I believe, and Honnell got 3. He's a big kid, about 280 pounds, and Rodgers stood in there trying to make the delivery, and, I mean, he banged him to the turf.
Waylon Prather standing inside his own 10. Miners 18th nationally in punt returns as Fenner awaits Prather's punt. Also in the top 40 in kickoff returns. On the Miners, Prather standing at his own 10, Fenner at his own 40-yard line. Miners are coming, they don't get there, they rough up Prather, and they're gonna keep the football. It doesn't matter what happens on the other end, so the ball can roll forever. They roughed up Prather, and San Jose State, if it's a 15-yarder, will keep the ball. If it's only a 5-yarder,
I think this is roughing.
Yeah, personal foul.
Defense, 15 yards, first down.
Well, that's what the Miners have not been doing, and Mike Price will not be happy with that.
I never liked, John, in that particular situation right there, when you're up 14-7, you don't have to make things happen in there. Don't take the chance to come in and rough that kicker.
That looked like Jimmy Smith. It looked like Jimmy Smith, although I'd be surprised that, he would be on the punt team. Is it 39? Jimmy Smith.
Yep.
Okay. So the Spartans on 3rd and long, 4th and long, they rough up the punter. That's the worst possible scenario for the Miners, and the Spartans with a new set of downs at their own 39.
Yeah, that's exactly what you don't want to do.
High backfield, Callier and Thompson behind Rodgers. They toss it back to Thompson, coming left, trying to find running room. 45, got the outside, and Joe Fleskoski takes him down, but not before he's got 11. And another San Jose State first down. So the Spartans having lots of success running the football in a 14-7 game with just over a minute to play in this first quarter.
That's that short toss with that lead back cutting off Rodriguez right there. Probably held him a little bit, but Thompson cuts back inside. Again, this kid knows how to run the football.
Doing a good job early on Robert Rodriguez, the Miners middle linebacker. First down at midfield. 14-7 Miners lead. Here comes Thompson coming right, and this time he's upended right at the line of scrimmage, and this time Robert Rodriguez made the play. Rodriguez upset the play. We'll call it a gain of 1 to the Miners' 49-yard line. Zach West also in there for UTEP. It'll be 2nd down and 9 yards to go.
Rodriguez, he got in there, but I think he got shaken up a little bit, John. Might have been his arm. He stuck his arm out there, and the kid tried to pull it out of his socket.
Twins to the left, another receiver right. Could be the last play of the first quarter. On 2nd and long, Rodgers hands to Lamar Ferguson is in there. Ferguson's in the corner and has another 1st down. Inside the 40, down at the 39-yard line. Miners are having a ton of trouble getting beaten up front by that San Jose State offensive line. It'll be 1st and 10. Just inside the Miner 40-yard line.
They're breaching that first line of defense out there at the off-tackle hole, John. The Miners have to have somebody in there to fill it. I expect Coach Hunley to stick somebody in there, a defensive back or something, to fill that hole off-tackle.
And that's going to be the last play of the first quarter with the Miners leading 14-7, but San Jose State with the momentum on the march as we get ready to start the second quarter of play. 14-7. The Miners over the San Jose State Spartans, back with second quarter action as game day continues from Northern California.
Fox Toyota is backing the UTEP team with a season-long tailgate party. Boy, Fox Toyota is opening huge holes in truck and SUV prices. You'll score with big rebates and discounts because we're passing all the savings on to you. Save $6,000 on Tundras, $4,000 on 4Runners, $3,000 on Highlanders, and $3,000 on Tacomas. Catch the year's best deal now at El Paso's number one. Boy, Fox Toyota.
with appliances from Appliance World. Our huge showroom is packed with a full range of appliances at the best prices in town, like washer-dryer sets starting at $448, refrigerators starting at $337, and stainless steel side-by-side refrigerators as low as $1,099. Appliance World has hundreds of appliances from Whirlpool, KitchenAid, and Frigidaire. With new stock coming in all the time, we can afford to give you great deals and in-house financing and layaway plans. Appliance World.
For worry-free air conditioning and heating, Gray Air Conditioning has been serving the El Paso and Las Cruces area with professional service and installation for over 25 years. Gray Air Conditioning offers 24-hour service and emergency service 7 days a week. Certified technicians provide maintenance and installation on all makes and models, such as Mastercool, Trane, and Lennox. Call the professionals for a free estimate at 544-1566.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Costa Ford, and we're going long with big savings. The Explorer is a first stringer, just $20,800 or $299 a month. And nothing beats the team power of an Eddie Bauer Expedition for just $29.5. And just for taking a test drive, you'll get two tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. Hey, the clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Individual game tickets for the two remaining minor home games are on sale at the UTEP Ticket Center and at all Ticketmaster outlets. 747-5234 for UTEP ticket information. To begin the second quarter, the teams switch ends. The Spartans attacking the northern goal. To your left, the Miners the southern goal to the right. First down, Spartans at the Miner 40-yard line on the march again, with the Miners getting pushed around a little bit up front. 14-7 out in front. Rodgers hands to Lamar Ferguson, bounces outside left, got some running room. 35, and to the 30-yard line, and close to another first down. Boy, that big San Jose State offensive line is really pushing the Miners around, Bernie.
Well, they're sealing, that's basically just a cutback by that running back that time. And again, you can see they're pushing them in the way of the UTEP defensive line the way they want them to go, and then he just breaks back across the grain.
Philip Moss, the safety man.
Ground level again. Here he comes back to the end of the grain, but you still got to seal that backside off.
Philip Moss, the safety man, finally had to make the tackle. It's second down, less than a yard. Rushing yards just about even. But you see the Spartans, their rush defense is dead last in college football, 117. Second down, less than a yard. They give it away to Thompson. He slips and goes down again. Funny, it's the Spartans that are having far more trouble with the footing thus far this afternoon than are the Miners. It's going to be a loss of about a yard, bringing up third down and a yard to go.
You got that lead back in there, and he comes in and makes a block, but Thompson looking to make one break. His feet won't hold him. He goes down.
Robert Rodriguez was there, but basically is just a courtesy. Miners 187 yards, the Spartans 106 through the first quarter of play. High backfield, double tight end set. They toss it back to Thompson, and he's close to the first down, taken down right at the 30-yard line. But where they're going to mark it, looks like he's short.
Yeah, he's short, John.
Now, we're probably in four-down territory. The way they're running the ball, I'm sure that Fitzhill will probably go for it here. But he is short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and less than a yard to go. The Spartans are 4 of 10 converting on fourth down this year, although Thompson comes out of the game. They're going to go with Lance Martin as the deep back, a senior, number 31, behind Callier. Miners in tight up front.
We got too many people on the field for the Miners.
Rodgers himself lunges for the first down and has plenty more, and we've got flags down. They probably counted, what, 13 or 12?
They were trying to get a timeout over there, the Miners were, because they had too many on there.
Before the ball was snapped, UTEP called a timeout. It'll be a timeout, first charge.
What are the flags about then? They called a timeout, but you had the flags down.
Yeah, but the head linesman, John, didn't have his whistle didn't blow or whatever, but they didn't know it back there. All they knew, there was 12 people on the field.
Wow. Good call by the Spartans. It would have been a first down. Instead, after the timeout, the first the Miners have used, San Jose State will try it again. But the Spartans have really responded well after falling behind 14-0 as Fitz Hill and Rich Cole and the referee are visiting about the particular timeout call. And apparently we've got, we can see them calling the timeout. The upper left of your screen, Miners are trying to get it done. You can do it from the sideline as well. And apparently someone behind the Miner defenders, one of the striped shirts, got the indication and called for the timeout just in time. So that time they went with a big backfield, but Rogers himself had plenty of yardage, and we'll see what the Spartans decide here.
You know, I'll tell you, John, it's a helpless feeling as a defensive coordinator sitting out there and you're trying to slow them down on a running game, and you can't. You make adjustment after adjustment, but you still can't slow them down. And Huntley right now is searching. He's searching for something.
Again, Callier and Martin behind Rogers. Fourth down and literally inches. Rogers himself, and I don't know that he got it. Maybe on second effort, but he didn't get very much that time.
Well,
he didn't need very much. The linesman on the near side with a left-footed spot, and that'll give him a first down. A fortuitous spot. Good job by the Miners, and only a good spot by the line judge on the near side of the linesman, actually. Gives the Spartans a first down, and they got very little, but they needed very little. So the Spartans continue their drive. This coming up will be the 11th play of this drive.
They're controlling the ball. Big series for the Miners. They've got to have somebody do something out there to slow them down.
Somebody got to make a play.
Yep.
Twins to the right, another receiver left. Thompson has returned. It's a long setback. Rogers again appears to be audibilizing. Senior quarterback. Has the snap, retreats to close, short drop, scrambling left, looking that way. Now he'll tuck it away and run, and uses the 239 pounds to get to the 25-yard line. Gains about four on the play, taken down by Godwin Acanduro. Justin Honnold just about had him, and somebody made a good peel-back block and allowed the Rogers to get the corner.
See, Honnold there, 56. It was the back, I believe, John. Or Honnold would have had him, but that big 230-pounder drugs some people, didn't it?
Second and six from the 25-yard line. Acanduro, the second leading Miners tackler besides Rodriguez. And again, Rogers appears to be changing the play. With three receivers in the pattern, this has been a familiar sight thus far. Rogers, deep drop to throw. Butch is on, hit as he throws, throws it up for grabs, and it's well overthrown and almost intercepted in the end zone by Philip Moss. James Jones was the intended receiver. That time, Tim Hundley came with quite a few, and they got to Rogers just as he let go of it.
Well, he saw that he was coming with some, he saw he was coming, John. Now, Moss has got to pick this off in there. A ball's put up in there. Moss has got a good, you can see him down at the bottom of your screen in there. He's got to make that, he's got to make that interception right there.
As it is third down and six. The Spartans at the Miners 25-yard line. High backfield, tight end to the right, receivers right and left. Rogers tosses to Thompson, trying to find running room. Joe Fleskoski and then Godwin Acanduro. An obvious passing down again, but this time the Miners were not fooled. And kind of an interesting call on third down. So now it's fourth down, and no doubt
they're not going to kick.
Apparently not. Rogers leaves the offensive unit on the nope. He brings in a couple of new wide receivers in Jones and Miranda. He's going to go for it on fourth down. Meanwhile, the Miners bring in a nickelback and Nate Grahan, number one, and take Ebok out of the game. So it'll be fourth down and about five from the 25-yard line. Rogers out of the shotgun. Snap is back, looks to his left side. Looking, now scrambles, dumps it over the middle. Caught by Thompson, first down inside the 20 at the 17-yard line. Rogers at the very last instant spotted Tyson Thompson and picks up the first down for the Spartans at the Miners 17.
He's looking around. You can see him there looking to his left, and says, I'll run. All of a sudden, picks him up, and there Thompson, and just throws it. Not a pretty pass, but effective.
Looked like Thomas Howard slipped down and trying to cover Thompson. Upcoming is the 15th play on this drive, and that Miner defense has got to be getting a little fatigued. 10 first downs now for the Spartans. Rogers on the draw, gives it to Thompson straight ahead, and runs into Robert Rodriguez, as he gets to the 15-yard line. Picks up a couple on the play. Looked like there was a hole, and all of a sudden it closed in a hurry. Robert Rodriguez will be second down and 8 yards to go. 10 minutes left to play. First half, the Miners clinging to a 14-7 lead after scoring the first 14 points.
Got a lead back in there. He finds a hole. He thinks he's got some running room, and boom, he runs into three people.
McAdura also on the play. Second down and 8 yards to go. Double tight end look. And Rodgers will put it in the air. Steps, delivers the ball left toward the end zone, and Skillern and Jamal Fenner were tied up, and the pass sailed incomplete. It'll be third down and long coming up.
Rodgers taking a beating out there. I'm telling you, they had him on the ground that time. He gets up slow, bends over. They've knocked the wind out of him about two or three times.
Third down and long. This will be the, I believe, the 17th play of this particular drive coming up.
17 plays, John.
Boy, that defense has got to be a little winded. Third down and 8 from the 15-yard line. Big play again right here. Twins to each side. Lance Martin in the backfield. Rodgers might be audibilizing. And Rodgers to put it up top. Miners blitz. Fires left. It's caught inside the 5. James Jones, he fumbles the ball. It's fought on by the Miners. James Jones lost the ball. James Jones lost it, and I thought Chris Minio coming back covered it up. Oh, it should be the Miners' ball.
Don't you? They have got to get
it. It is the Miners' ball. It is the Miners' ball. Absolutely. That's the right call. He was on his feet when that ball came out of there. And Chris Minio peeling back did come up with it.
Here's your pass in here. It's just streaking across the middle in here. He gets a hit there, slipped. Goes down, tries to come back, he's losing the ball. Yep. Absolutely the right call.
And Chris Minio falls on it at the 1 yard line.
You can see him slip, his knee never went down.
Moss and Drahan made the play. The Spartans had the ball for nearly 8 minutes and ran 17 plays.
You can see it
turn it over.
See it coming back out of his back that time, trying to hold on, no chance.
Miners from their own 1 yard line. Jimmy Smith in the backfield. Palmer gives it to Smith coming left, and Jimmy gets out to about the 2 yard line for a gain of a yard. It's very important the Miners are able to get a first down somehow here and keep that defense off the field and try and flip that field position.
What did you say, John? That was 17 plays for
and
8 minutes.
They kept the ball almost 8 minutes.
That's an amazing drive, and I'll tell you what, it'll wear your defense out.
Miners, as we told you earlier, 13 interceptions this year, now have forced a turnover in 27 straight games. Fifth nationally in takeaways coming into the game. Jackson now is returned. They give it away to Howard, trying to find running room left. Crosses the 5, crosses the 10, and they say he goes out of bounds where? Right at the 10-yard line, right about a yard short of the first down, but a good gain of 8 for Howard Jackson, and it'll be third down and a yard to go. Brian Nunez escorted him out of bounds.
Base handoff here again, stretch look outside, but nice job, nice block outside. Can you imagine 160-pounder taking those guys on like that and gaining yards?
Split backfield, Shamwan Smith behind Palmer. They give it away to Shamwan coming left, and Shamwan is taken down short of the first down. They had the jumbo backfield in there, and the Miners can't get a first down. And it'll be fourth down.
Somebody snuck underneath there. I couldn't see his number, John.
Looked like Josh Powell or Jamonte Cox making the play. So the Miners are going to have to punt it away. 3 plays and out. And Bryce Benikos will kick from the end zone about the place. He had one blocked for a touchdown last week at Louisiana Tech.
And Jones back there in the deep.
Jones standing at his own 45-yard line. So the Miners run 3 plays and we go back on defense. There's the snap, no pressure, and here comes Benico's kick, and again, a very poor kick off the side of his foot. Again, it takes a minor bounce, and Benico's quite fortunate. He's hit 2 very poorly this afternoon. It does go out of bounds at the 46-yard line. As we take a timeout with 7:57 till halftime, 14-7 Miners back to San Jose after this.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Katsa Nissan, and we're going long with big savings. Tackle a Titan King Cat for just $19,998. or go for two in an 05 Ultimate. It's just $18,998. Even better, just for taking a test drive, you'll get two tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. The clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Ready for that dream home? Mountain Vista Builders can help make that dream come true. Drop by one of our furnished model homes citywide and see the different floor plans we have to offer. We make homes starting in the mid-60s to over $200,000. Standard features include ceramic tile throughout, alarm system, Whirlpool appliances, landscaping allowance, surround sound pre-wire, and for your peace of mind, a one-year builder's warranty. Visit Mountain Vista Builders at any of our six locations and start living your dream.
How about some jeans? How about some boots? Like our black bullhide western boot, only $49.95. And our newest boot, all leather alligator prints, only $99.99. How about boots? Get them on.
Before we resume play, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification from Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. This is the UTEP Miners Football Network. You'll find the UTEP Ticket Center at the corner of Mesa and Baltimore, right next door to the Don Haskins Center. Open Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Open on game days at 10 a.m. Spartans with a first down at their own 46-yard line following a 44-yard Benicos punt. Spartans to the edge in field position. Rogers a deep drop to throw. Steps up. Now will scramble and run. 50, 45, dragging Jeremy Jones with him all the way to the 42-yard line, and that's going to be enough yardage for a San Jose State first down. He just went right up, stepped up right around the pass rush. And Jeremy Jones, along with his brother Victor from Piedmont Hills High School here in San Jose, made the tackle.
He's looking. He can't find anything. You can see that hole opened up inside. He takes it. Again, 230 pounds. Jones comes up and hits him, but can't slow him down. He gets an extra five.
First down, Spartans at the Miner 43-yard line. Thompson, the lone setback. Rogers turns, gives it away to Thompson, trying to find running room, skips over one man, then runs into Robert Rodriguez, but not before he picks up four, down to the 39-yard line. Made a nice spin move on Philip Moss, sidestepped Ebach. It'll be second down, and 6 yards to go. 14-7, Miners were out quickly, but the Spartans have come back in a big way.
Evidently, they saw something a couple of weeks ago in their running game that they could control people, and they've done it. They worked hard against Hawaii. You got, 325 against them.
And that's no small chore, particularly at Aloha Stadium. Rodgers gives it away to Thompson. Sidesteps one man. That's Lamar Ferguson, and he's close to another first down at the Miner 33-yard line. Chris Minio finally tripped him up, but Lamar Ferguson, the diminutive Ferguson, doing a nice job sidestepping the first man he saw.
I think he sidestepped Ryan Givens, I believe is what it was. Then he cut back inside. Now this kid's got a little bit more shake and move than Thompson does. Thompson a little bit bigger, but you know, you've got to get your feet planted and move toward him.
And a measure for the first down as they call for the chains from the far sideline. Miners averted disaster, or at least the tying score moments ago when James Jones fumbled inside the 5-yard line. It is a first down for San Jose State. But the Miners couldn't get a first down, had to punt it away. And again, playing field position, the Spartans are moving again.
You're looking at little Ferguson is 5'5", 151 pounds. So he's back behind those big offensive linemen, 6'6", 6'7", and the defense can't see.
A Miner 33-yard line. Twins to each side. Ferguson in the backfield. And they give it away to Lamar Ferguson. Coming right, big hole again. 30, breaks the tackle. Looked like his knee went down. They say no. Did the ball come out? Yeah, the ball came out, and I think the Miners have it. Lamar Ferguson turns it over. Back-to-back turnovers. The official across the way signaled UTEP ball. It is a first down for the Miners inside the San Jose State 25-yard line.
Well, you need those turnovers. You need some kind of luck. Tell you what, now we'll take a look at him out here. He hits the hole. He's breaking out. He gets hit right here.
Looks like his knee went down, Bernie. Let's see. Flaskowski hits him. Looked like his knee went down. No, he puts his hand down.
Absolutely.
Oh, it looked like the knee went down.
Sure did.
Miners get a break. I saw it with the naked eye. And then Jeremy Jones is the one that comes up with a fumble.
Rodriguez knocked it out.
First down at the 22. Palmer gives to Jackson. And now on the flea flicker. Back to Palmer. In trouble. Palmer's going to go down. And we've got a holding call as well. Spartans were not fooled. They were looking for Chris Francis, but the Spartans did not bite. And it is a holding call against UTEP. And everything going wrong except the turnovers for UTEP.
Well, I think it's a spot foul too, John. Wow.
Holding number 73 of the offense. Decline, second down.
James Riley, the redshirt freshman from Fort Worth, the guilty party. His man was about to sack Palmer, so he reached out and tugged him down. And the Miners having all kinds of problems after getting out so quickly here in San Jose.
One thing we haven't seen from the Miners in here, John, I'm telling you what, San Jose at this particular time is dominating that line of scrimmage.
First, make it second and 20 from the 12-yard line. Palmer turns, hands to Jackson, coming left. Not much running room. He does scramble for maybe a yard. And now what you've got is a fired-up San Jose State squad.
Absolutely, and somehow you got to find yourself first down in there to keep that defense off, because they can't continue to be lucky and get fumble after fumble after fumble.
Third down now, and about 20 yards to go over the first down. Cox and McNamara on that last tackle. Miners bring three receivers to the right side, another receiver left. Miners just one of three on third down. As Palmer off the play fake, the right flat, it's Gibbons, 15, 20, 25. There's a marker down, and no doubt another hold against the Miners. It was probably either Francis or Johnny Lee Higgins blocking upfield.
We'll see.
Have the Spartans been penalized yet? I don't think so. I don't think San Jose State has been penalized yet, and that goes against the Miners. We'll try and get the penalty yardage for you when we get an opportunity, but I don't think San Jose State has been penalized once for 5 yards. Actually, they'll probably decline it and take the football since the Miners are about 5 yards short of the first
down. Holding number 21 of the offense, decline, fourth down.
Johnny Lee Higgins trying to block up field. Miners' third straight three and out after marching more than 80 yards on their first two possessions for touchdowns. And Benikos, who's not hit a solid punt yet, and yet averaging 45, Benikos drops inside his own 15-yard line. Miners still leading 14-7, less than 5.5 minutes left till halftime. Miners letting the clock run down, and wisely so. Trying to get as much of a breather as they can for that beleaguered defense. There's the snap, no pressure, and this time Benikos hits a boomer. High spiral, Jones at the 25-yard line. That's some running room, and now it closes down. He gets to the 28 and is met by a trio of Miners. Aaron King along with J.D. Hearn and Marshall Sanford among them. So a 48-yard punt and a 3-yard return. Timeout with 4:54 till halftime. Miners lead by 7. Back to San Jose after this.
If a lunar rover can get out of a ditch on the moon, if a tugboat can tow an enormous freighter, if an M1 tank can have a heavy-duty Allison transmission, then why can't your truck? At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Sierra line of pickups. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
Gentlemen, it's true. NBA League Pass can get you up to 40 games per week. Elton, can I watch the Clippers play if I live in Kalamazoo?
With NBA League Pass, you can.
Ron, what's the League Pass motto?
Come on, Artest, you know this.
closing is the key to success, and never forget it, guys.
Call now to order NBA League Pass for just $169. When it comes to sports, we're on your team.
Stupid, stupid, stupid.
Which high-definition big screen is right for you? CRT, DLP, flat panel, or LCD? It can be confusing, but at Pat Goff Appliance TV Warehouse, our personalized red carpet service make buying a new Toshiba high-definition big screen easy. Plus, on all Toshiba high-definition big screens, including the exclusive cinema series, you pay nothing till 2006. Pat Goff Appliance TV Warehouse in Las Cruces and in El Paso, where we'll deliver your new Toshiba high-definition big screen in 5 hours, guaranteed.
Dale Rogers getting set to lead the Spartans offensively. They'll start at their own 28-yard line. At least the Miners have gotten back somewhat the field position at this point, and they can put something together defensively.
Yeah, they've been fighting field position for the past three or four drives in here, and now Benico's good punt.
From their own 28, Thompson the lone setback, three receivers in the pattern. Rogers gives it away to Thompson, straight ahead, got some running room, breaks a tackle, breaks another, and has got about 8 yards on first down before Chris Minio could bring him down. This is about as much as we've seen Miners struggle in recent weeks against the running game.
Well, again, they've been running this play all day, and there's just zone blocking up front.
Zach West was being held.
Yeah, and so was Minio, but this kid, again, you hit him and he bounces off of you. Great balance.
Second down and 2 yards to go. They had a big handful of Zach West jersey. Clear as day in the picture. On second and short, Thompson again is cut down for no gain. Is that Joe Ward that made the big play pinching down from his defensive end spot? I think Joe West did a nice job. Loss of about a yard on the play. It'll bring up third down and 3 for San Jose State. Good job by the sophomore, Joe Ward.
Somehow Hundley's trying to get penetration in there so he can get him before he makes that breakthrough, that off-tackle hole.
Troy Collado, number 44 in there at middle linebacker for the Miners on 3rd and 3. And Rogers changing the play. Twins to each side with Thompson behind him. There's the snap. Thompson carries. Thompson with a first down and more. And Thompson across the 40 out to the 44-yard line. And Philip Moss, the safety man, again had to make the tackle as they just pushed the Miners around up front.
Very confident with what they're doing out there. Not taking a lot of chances. They're controlling that ball. They're going to wear their UTEP defense down. Somehow you got to get a fill in there by a linebacker or a safety man, defensive back.
That's not been happening often enough in this first half. First down at the 44-yard line. Rogers off the play fake, back to throw, being chased by Alex Obamese. He's going to be brought down. They came also with a corner blitz, and Jamal Fenner sacks him back at the 36-yard line. Second of the season, second of Jamal Fenner's career. The senior from Austin Reagan High School, Jamal Fenner with a sack. He sidestepped Obamese, but not Jamal Fenner.
Again, Tim Hundley, such an experienced defensive coordinator, and he goes out there and he says, you know, he said, they've been running that ball. I think I'm going to put some pressure on him. Puts a ton of pressure from the right side, sacks him.
Loss of 8. It'll be second down and 18 yards to go. Rogers out of the shotgun. Has the snap, looks to throw. Looking, fires over the middle of the field. Caught by Miranda at midfield. First down and all the way to the Miner 43-yard line. He hit Casey Miranda in stride, and Adrian Ward finally took him down. But not before San Jose State picks up 21 yards and a first down on second and long.
This kid, I tell you, let him set in there. You're talking to a five-year guy, and he throws back across the sidearm back to the receiver, and the receiver slips going down, but that's a good first down.
Philip Moss trailing on the play. Here's Thompson, and he's hit and taken down quickly by Godwin Acanduro for a loss of a yard. Back at the 44-yard line of the Miners. It'll be second down and 11. That time, Acanduro filled the hole.
Well, he looked like he was a little bit mad out there, John. Those guys are getting beat around a little bit, and Acanduro and Howard, and that they're coming straight at him, and that tests your manhood. You know, am I going to stand there, and am I going to get pushed around, or am I going to make a stand?
Twin receivers right, one to the left. Miners nearly jump offside, and now Rogers steps back to change the play. Thompson is the deep back. Rogers gives it away to Thompson. Coming right, cuts it back. inside the 40, down near the 36-yard line. Gains about 8 yards on the play. It'll leave the Spartans with third down and three with a minute and a half left in this first half. Philip Moss has played a lot for Mark Doughty at safety in this second quarter and throughout this first half. Don't know if Doughty might not have been shaken up.
Well, somebody, John, but against this particular club right here, you got to be physical because they're big up front. They got a big old strong quarterback, a big strong running back that you got to really hang on to get him down.
Third down, 3 yards to go. They go with an eye backfield. Collier is blocking back. They toss it back to Ferguson coming left, and he's not going to get the first down. He's hit right at the line of scrimmage by Joe Ward and Robert Rodriguez and also Joe Fleskoski coming from strong safety to make the play. No gain. It'll be fourth down and 3 yards to go.
It's tough to quick toss the Miners because they got that good speed. There's your toss, trying to get out around the end. But again, these guys can run. They're vulnerable today, hitting inside the tackle and open that tackle hole. That's where they've been having problems.
30 seconds left to play in the half, and the Spartans apparently are in no hurry. I'm not sure what the thing is here. They don't use a timeout. They've got two left. They're letting the clock run down. And frankly, I don't understand why they didn't take a shot at least getting a touchdown. They could probably try a field goal, but Fitzhill and the Spartans just let it run. 19 seconds till halftime, 14-7 Miners. Will return to San Jose after these words.
Fox Toyota is backing the UTEP team with a season-long tailgate party.
Go Miners!
Boy, Fox Toyota is opening huge holes in truck and SUV prices. You'll score with big rebates and discounts because we're passing all the savings on to you. Save $6,000 on Tundras, $4,000 on 4Runners, $3,000 on Highlanders, and $3,000 on Tacomas. Catch the year's best deal now at El Paso's number one. Boy, Fox Toyota.
Tony here, better known as a warehouse guy at Appliance World. It's a busy man's job here to keep all brands and appliances always in stock. It's not easy. Here's another truckload. They don't last here in the showroom. Not at these prices. Get a package, and you'll save even more. You want to know where I bought my big screen TV? At Appliance World. If you buy it somewhere else, you'll pay too much. So come by Appliance World at I-10 East and exit Lee Trevino.
Glow.
Yes, it does. It also runs our clocks, keeps our fridge cold, and my coffee warm.
If I plug my dolly in, will she get warm?
No, Nina. Electricity's not something you play with.
Your dad's right, Nina.
It's Ernie G. Watt.
From our electric company.
You know, electricity's a wonderful part of everyday life. But safety has to come first. And Dad, if you need help, you can always call El Paso Electric, your electric company.
19 seconds left to play until halftime. The Spartans letting the clock run down. Then they used a timeout, I do believe. And it's fourth down. Kind of interesting strategy here.
Well, they've got something that he certainly has something he's got in mind.
Double tight end set. Rodgers under center. Thompson behind him. And Rodgers will throw. Being chased. He's going to be taken down for a loss. Boy, did that backfire. Alex Obamis brought him down. You really have to question the Spartan strategy. I mean, they had plenty of time to get something done, and they ran the clock down, and then were sacked. Miners are going to escape the first half with a lead.
The logic didn't make a lot of sense there, did it, John? He lets it run down, then he goes out and looks like he's going to throw a short out right there. I thought he was going for the deep end zone, and they're going to throw a short out. Doesn't make sense.
Well, let's see what the Miners do here. With 13 seconds left to play, they have two timeouts left and good field position at their own 44-yard line. Palmer's going to throw. Why not? Twins to each side. Great time. He's taking a shot up the center of the field. Daniel Robinson intercepted off the tip. Brian Nunez, 30, 35, 40, center of the field. Cuts back. Trying to buy running room. Now laterals to Jarrell Hardy, who gives ground. This is going to end the half, and hopefully the Miners can get him. We've got a flag down. It looks like Jarrell Hardy may score at the 30, at the 20, and he's going to be hit and go down. We've got a flag back upfield. No doubt an illegal block against San Jose State. And that will probably end the half.
Did you see Howard Jackson? He ran all over that field knowing he may be the last line of defense. He must have run 70 yards out there making sure he got that kid stopped.
There was a flag down back up field. Let's see.
On the return, illegal block in the back is declined. The half is over.
All right. So no worse than a punt. And penalty would have nullified any touchdown that they might have scored, but the Miners peeled back and made the play. It is halftime, a wild first half here in San Jose. The Miners leave the field with a 14-7 lead. Back with their halftime festivities from Spartan State. There all day, but I'm sure they've talked to each other. I'm sure that they're going to get squared around out there, especially Tim Huddley. Hey, we've got to shut down some of that running game.
Miners scored the only time they got into the red zone in that first half, and now 14 out of their last 14. They've been very good this year. Other scores from around the country last night. Hawaii was of no help for the Miners, as Boise State throttled them pretty good. Iowa over Illinois in the Big Ten. West Virginia just got by Rutgers, averting the upset, and Oklahoma State likewise in Stillwater had to come from behind to take care of Oklahoma State. Northwestern did upset Purdue, the Boilermakers' second straight loss. Interesting to see how that Big Ten shakes out once they choose bowl teams and the representative of the Sun Bowl. Tennessee over Lou Holtz in South Carolina. As first the Miners and now the Spartans make their way out onto the field. Indiana, the upset winner over Minnesota, no doubt knocking the Gophers out of the top 25. And in the fourth quarter, Georgia winning the cocktail party over Florida. Steve Spurrier headed back to the Swamp.
You know, I think he might be, John. I think he would like to be. But there's an awful lot of uproar over Zook. He was a well-liked guy down there.
Guess what? Miners are going to be on defense again to start the second half of play as Michigan State is winning at the Big House in the fourth quarter, 20-10 over Michigan. Mike Price hoping to get the Miners through an unbeaten October with an open date coming next. How big would a victory here today be with a week off next week and then two home games?
Boy, absolutely. I mean, they control their destiny right here with this ball game right here, John. But I tell you, watch those guys on film the other day, and they scared me. This San Jose State team scared me, but not so much. I didn't think that they would be able to control the ground game like this on the Miners.
Fitzhill on the other side trying to find a way to stick that ball in the end zone and take advantage of all the field position. Miners can be heard and seen throughout the year, both at home and away, on the Miners' new video audio package, which can be found at the Miners' official and redesigned athletic website at utepathletics.com. The video comes your way during all home games, both men's and women's basketball and men's football, and audio home and away throughout the year. All football and men's basketball games and selected women's basketball games as well. Check it out. Video audio broadcast wherever you are at utepathletics.com, the official website of UTEP Miners Athletics. Miners will attack the southern goal to the right, the Spartans the northern goal to the left here in the third quarter. And again, San Jose State deferred its choice to the second half, so they will take the football to start this third quarter of play, and Reagan Schneider will do the honors. Spartans very dangerous bringing punts and kicks back, so we'll see how it goes to start the second half. If there is a breeze, it would be at the Miners' backs in this third quarter. And we're underway. Schneider with a good high kick. It'll drive George a couple of yards deep, and he's going to bring it out. Starts left, crosses the 10. Trying to find running room at the 15. Sidesteps one man. And now will be taken down just across the 20-yard line by, look like, Victor Jones. Victor Jones and Mike Pettis. Pettis from San Elizario, and, of course, Victor Jones from Piedmont Hills High School here in San Jose. Quite a few of the Jones family and friends here at the game this afternoon. So now we'll see what adjustments Tim Hundley has made.
It's going to be fun to see in here, but again, that running back is, I think he's as good or better than Boats from last week.
Thompson in the backfield. Tight end is to the left. Out of the play fake, they're going to bootleg right. Rogers dumps it over the middle, and Wagey, the tight end, trying to make a diving grab, but apparently it short-hopped him. And they say no catch. Wagey trying to make his first grab of the day, but not so. So it'll be second down and 10. That's just a poor throw by Rogers.
Yeah, somebody, who is that going up there? 92.
Ebok
goes up and well,
looked like a pretty good catch.
His hands were underneath of it. There's another angle of it.
Nice job by Wagey.
You bet.
Well, might have hit the ground just as he rolled over. Anyhow, second down and 10 yards to go. This Mineo went into the backfield and gets back on side as Rogers was audibleized. Wow, looked like he was stunning, too. And they do stunt. Rogers to throw, fires left. Miranda again, wide open, 35-40, dragging tacklers all the way to the 46-yard line. Godwin Acanduro made the tackle. Casey Miranda had caught three passes all year long coming into the game, and he's had a big day. Miranda, a senior from Santa Maria, and it is the first down for the Spartans.
Every time they see that pressure coming from UTEP in there, he runs that skinny post to Miranda. He's been successful, three times out of it?
25 yards on that play. First and 10. Spartans approaching midfield, trailing 14-7. Twins to each side. And Rogers hands to Thompson. Left side, running room again. 50, 45, near side at the 40. He's all the way near the 35-yard line. They're going to spot him at the 37, and another San Jose State first down and a gain of 17. The Miners continue to struggle against the ground game. Rodriguez and Acanduro making the tackle, but way upfield.
And just base hole, they're coming out. It looks to me like, John, just basically off of that they're bringing one of those receivers back in and sealing off.
Mark Dowdy must be injured because Philip Moss again starts the second half at safety. A lot less experienced than is Dowdy. First down at the 36-yard line of the Miners. Rogers again changing the play. Twins to each side. And the center moves the football. The center, Matt Cantu, moved the football without snapping it, so that's going to be 5 yards against San Jose State. Here's Rich Colon, our referee.
Illegal snap on the offense, number 79. The down is Stilton.
And they say 79, but Cantu, the center, is number 76, an upside down 9.
John, they'll come up to the line of scrimmage, and Rogers will take a look. Upstairs, the coordinators take a look. They call down there and say, wait a minute, we want to change the call. Rogers turns around and looks at the sideline. They'll change the call from the box to the floor down there.
So it's first and 15. The ball spotted back at the Miner 41-yard line. Twins to the right, another receiver left. And Dale Rogers, the senior quarterback, turns, play fake. Back to throw, has time, now is hit as he throws. The ball is up for grabs, Moss can get it. It is intercepted, Acanduro at the 20. Oh. It's Howard at the 30, Thomas Howard at the 40. Thomas Howard is down at the 40-yard line. Third turnover of the day, and Tyson Thompson made the tackle. Rogers was hit just as he threw. The ball popped up in the air, and peeling back, Thomas Howard with the interception.
Looked like Rodriguez had got on the pressure on him in here, you bet. And look at Howard come out of there like a center fielder over his shoulder. Got that great 4-3 speed, breaking up field. Thompson was lucky to get him. If he hadn't have got him, you'd have looked at probably another 30, 35 yards.
Only the fifth time Rodgers has been intercepted this season. First down Miners at their own 40-yard line. They come out with two tight ends. Check that, two receivers to the right. All three turnovers for the Spartans today. Palmer to throw. Steps, delivers left. It's caught by Jackson. He's hit immediately. He'll be shoved backwards, but forward progress to the 44-yard line. Jarrell Hardy, the corner on that side, came up to make the play. But it'll be second down and 6 yards to go.
I know that Mike Price and Tim Hunley both, John, are saying right now, please, please move that ball down the field and give that defense some rest.
Second and 6 at the 44. Miners leading 14-7. This time, Twins to each side. Jackson behind Palmer. And Palmer turns, gives to Jackson. Running room, 45, 50-yard line, and is close to a first down. Brought down by Sean McNamara, who is their outstanding defensive lineman, the senior a year ago. Apparently, they're a little short of the first down. It'll be third down and less than a yard to go.
Zone play up the middle, and he just, you know, all you got to do is give Jackson a little bit of hole. He's looking for some space. Found it, got him, what, 6?
Triple I in the backfield. Palmer quickly to the line of scrimmage, gets to Chamois. First down and more as he hammers into Spartans territory. Inside the 45, down to the 44-yard line, where Josh Powell tugs him down. And the Miners keep the drive alive. Not many first downs for UTEP, if any, in that second quarter. I don't think they had a first down. Not one first down in that second quarter of play.
I don't know if they had the ball much, though, did they, John?
First down since the first quarter for UTEP. The one Spartan drive took up almost 8 minutes. First down at the 44. Palmer on the counter gives to Jackson. He's hit in the backfield. Tony Ficklin. Number 49 pinched down from his defensive end spot and dumps Jackson for about a 3-yard loss back at the 47-yard line.
You take a look at Ficklin coming down there, and they tried to block him coming out with a trap of some type. The guard coming out there, but the guard missed him. Didn't get out there, and Ficklin hammered
him. Jose Garcia missed him. It'll be second down and 13 yards to go. Again, Twins to each side. Spartan showing blitz. They back away as Palmer fades to throw. Fires up the left sideline. Francis wide open. 25, 20, 10, 5. It'll be first and goal for the Miners inside the 5-yard line. Jordan Palmer finding Chris Francis, and Francis broke a couple of tackles. It'll be first and goal Miners after a 43-yard pass hookup. Palmer to Francis.
Now take a look at this. They got pressure coming from the left side in here. They pick it up. He has time to look. Great amount of time to look. He sees Francis in that seam down there. Good job.
Francis did a good job after the catch. First and goal at the 4-yard line. Miners go with a shotgun. Jackson standing to Palmer's left. Snap is back. Palmer, and now flags and whistles, stop play. We might have had an offside or a procedure call. Let's see. One of the Spartans jumped, but did the Miners jump first? We'll see.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense. 5 yards, down to still one.
Rich Colin, please give us the number.
I know they were going to run a draw in there to Jackson that time, but John, down in that area, four down area, I prefer that they get in that three-man eye set and just punish him going into the end zone.
Miners in the last 4 games, perfect in the red zone. It's now first and goal from the 9-yard line. Jackson to be back. And Palmer will air it out. Looks, going to the right side of the end zone. He's got a man out there. Gibbons has it, or is it intercepted? It's incomplete. Gibbons got his hands on it. Good coverage by Brian Nunez. Not a bad throw by Palmer, but Nunez broke it up. It'll be second down and goal to go. That was close.
It's a fade out there, and I tell you what, he throws the ball up. I thought Gibbons had it at first, but Nunez comes in there and knocks it out at the last minute.
Good job by Nunez. Yeah. A good wrestling match between the two. Second down and goal from the 9-yard line. Twins to the right, another receiver left. Jackson to the back, tight end to the left. Miners leading 14-7. Palmer fades to Cole, looking right, throws that way. It's caught inside the five. Johnny Lee Higgins, touchdown, Miners! Six consecutive games with a touchdown catch for the sophomore from Sweeney, Texas, Johnny Lee Higgins. The Miners have extended their lead.
Run a fade in the corner, the play before, and then come back and run a skinny post right there. The cornerback goes down and he slips. Higgins got the advantage. Touchdown.
Benico's hold. Reagan Schneider to find the extra point. Kick is on its way, and the kick is good, and the Miners extend their lead, drawing first blood here in the second half. 10 minutes, 8 seconds left, third quarter. Miners 21, Spartans 7. Game day rolls on from Spartan Stadium.
Great deals and a huge selection. We've got it all at Sunland Park Pontiac Buick GMC. The 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix GT1 leads the pack in power, handling, and affordability. Only $245 a month. Or test drive the 2004 GMC Yukon XL, rated by J.D. Powers as the most dependable full-size SUV, only $467 a month.
Great service, great prices, great selection. At Sunland Park, Pontiac Buick GMC.
Sunland Park makes it fun again.
The El Paso Times, real life, real news. Every day we bring you news about your world. The pictures, the stories, the events, and the people who are part of life right here in El Paso. Local news from your community and around the world. Sports, living, business, entertainment, and lots more. For convenient home delivery, call 546-6300 today. The El Paso Times. Real life, real news.
How about some jeans? Some boots, like our black bullhide western boot, only $49.95. And our newest boot, all leather alligator prints, only $99.99. Cowtown boots, get them on.
Get them on.
Before we resume play, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. From Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California, this is the UTEP Miners Football Network. Miners draw first blood, scoring on their first possession of the second half, and lead it now 21-7. What a resilient team. We talked last week. What a resilient squad this has become under Mike Price.
They seem to go out and they don't get flustered, John. That's a tribute to that coaching staff. They go out and they go to work. And what needs to be done, they do.
Here's Reagan Schneider's kickoff. Good high boot. Be taken at the goal line by John Broussard. 15, 20, now he's in the clear. 30, and Broussard gets across the 40-yard line. Miners have had some problems covering kicks today. That has not been a problem in recent weeks. But today, they have given the Spartans some field position. San Jose State will start at the 40. 60 yards in 7 plays, 2 minutes 55 seconds. Jordan Palmer's 14th touchdown pass of the year, a 9-yarder to Johnny Lee Higgins, his 6th touchdown reception, and his 6th in as many games, has extended the lead, and now the defense will try and shut down Dale Rogers and crew. But a good return by Broussard. First down at the 40, ball on the right hash, two receivers to the short side, and now Jones comes in motion left. Rogers, a deep drop to throw, the screen left, caught by Thompson. The 30, cuts it back, trying to find running room, there is none. Robert Rodriguez trips him up for a loss of 4. Back at the 36-yard line, good pursuit by the Miners. It'll be second down and 14 yards to go.
Now they have run motion much. You come across in there, John, and you can see the linebackers a little bit confused at first, then they get it. Now you got your outside-inside squeeze. He's got to go inside. You can see that right there, and then the pursuit takes it.
Second and 14, twins to each side. Rogers now pulls up, looks to the sideline. And almost, I thought, called a timeout. Rose up again. He'll run the play, gives it away to Thompson. Coming right and runs into Rodriguez again. And this time for a gain of one to the 37-yard line. And it'll be third down and 13 yards to go for the Spartans. And now this UTEP defense, they can't let the Spartans out of the hole here. Third and long.
You've got the two leading tacklers in the whack out there in Ezekiel and Rodriguez, John. Rodriguez is having a big, big day today.
Third down and 13 yards to go. Out of the shotgun, back to the right of Rodgers, twins to each side. Rodgers awaiting the snap, looks back, looks upfield to throw. Has time, now it breaks down, he's gonna be sacked! Chris Minio knifes through inside the 30-yard line, and Minio's got the sack. It'll be fourth down. And San Jose State now 3 of 10 on third down this afternoon. Minio with a big play.
There was that was a twist in there. You could see between West and Minio, and West came around, and Minio just kept trudging and trudging. Finally got to Rodgers and put him on his back.
And trudging would be the correct terminology. As Prather stands inside his own 20-yard line, kicking to Jamal Fenner. The shadows now extending halfway across the field here at Spartan Stadium. Snaps a little high, Prather pulls it down, and here's his kick, high but very short. Fenner says get away from it, it hits it midfield, and is gonna take a bounce towards the goal line, and will be down inside the 45-yard line. Miners will have great field position, leading 21-7 with 7:42 left in the third quarter. The Miners have this thing flipped around? We'll find out as we continue with game day from San Jose.
Fox Toyota is backing the UTEP team with a season-long tailgate party.
Go Lions!
Boy, Fox Toyota is opening huge holes in truck and SUV prices. You'll score with big rebates and discounts because we're passing all the savings on to you. Save $6,000 on Tundras, $4,000 on 4Runners, $3,000 on Highlanders, and $3,000 on Tacomas. Catch the year's best deal now at El Paso's number one, Boy, Fox Toyota.
A storm hits, and El Paso Electric is there. People count on us to get the power back on. Tough job. All in a night's work. Rely on El Paso Electric.
Gentlemen, it's true. NBA League Pass can get you up to 40 games per week. Elton, can I watch the Clippers play if I live in Kalamazoo?
With NBA League Pass, you can.
Ron, what's the League Pass motto?
Come on, Artest, you know this.
Closing is the key to success, and never forget it, guys.
Call now to order NBA League Pass for just $169. When it comes to sports, we're on your team.
Stupid, stupid, stupid.
Basketball season is upon us for both the UTEP men and the women. Great promise for the season ahead. For season tickets, call the Miners season ticket hotline at 747-6150, 747-6150 for basketball season ticket information. First down Miners at their own 44. Let's see if they can capitalize on favorable field position. Palmer, the hits right, caught by Boyd, gets a block, 45 and up to the 48-yard line. For a gain of four, Larry Collins, a reserve corner, wrapped him up. It'll be second down at 6 yards to go. First three and out for the Miner defense today.
Well, let me tell you something. They have been taxed out there, but they haven't broken so far. And they're looking to take this ball right down in and score and take the pressure off that defense, John.
Second and six from the 48-yard line. More than midway through this third quarter, the Miners up 21-7. Palmer with twins to each side, surveys the Spartan defense, might be changing the play. Jackson in the backfield, Palmer hands to Jackson, he juggles it, now tries to get outside, breaks a couple of tackles, crosses midfield. Howard Jackson is absolutely remarkable. He's close to a first down at the 46, Anthony Flores on the tackle. Jackson juggled the handoff, and somehow he not only corralled it, he almost picked up the first down.
He's tough, dead in his tracks. I'm telling you what, didn't have a good handle on that ball and took off inside. There he is right there. That kid is something else. 160 pounds of dynamite.
Third down about a half yard to go from the 46 and a half yard line. Miners will go with a split backfield, a wing right set. Three tight ends in the game. Off the play fake, Palmer to throw. Scrambling right. Will he run? Yeah, he's got the first down inside the 40. And Palmer goes out of bounds. Good job. Great ball fake by Palmer. And Palmer's got the first down inside the 40 at the 37-yard line. Boy, that as much as anything shows how he has matured as a player.
That kid's growing up, John. You can look at him in here. They want to go deep, fake short.
Look at that ball fake. Look at him hiding it.
Got it back there. He's looking down. The San Jose State's got it covered. He knows he needs it first. Broken down on the right side. He goes and gets it. I tell you what, the kid is growing up.
First down at the 37-yard line. All three receivers, rather, out to the left. Another to the right side. Jackson behind Palmer. Sophomore quarterback. Rises up now. The Spartans show blitz, so we'll see if he changes the play. They show blitz again. They're coming. Palmer to throw. Fires right. Caught on the near side by Jason Boyd. Steps out of bounds at the 33-yard line, and that's a gain of about 4 on the play. Let's call it a gain of 5 to the 32. It'll be 2nd and 5. Palmer switched to this play, Bernie.
Yep, just a short out in there, and he knew it was going to be there because he was going to get one-on-one coverage out there and stands up and drills it right in. I can't tell you, John, mature is a good word for this kid.
2nd and 5. Miners with the edge in total yards this afternoon. Palmer turns, gives to Jackson, looking for running room. Hammers, gets bent backwards to the 30-yard line. Let's hope Howard gets up, because he was bent awkwardly backwards on that play.
He dropped the ball, but the official said his knee was down.
Jackson is still on the ground and somehow gets up. And has a slight limp, but somehow it appears to be okay, although he's coming off toward the far sideline. Matt Costello hit him. Boy, did he get bent backwards.
That's just 160 pounds of sinew out there. Tough to hurt that kid.
Says to Don Hearn, the minor trainer, get out of here, I'm fine. Third down and about 2 from the 40. Austin is the lone setback. Palmer turns, off the play fake, bootleg right, steps, fires right. It's caught by Gibbons, but he's going to be hit and
didn't make it.
No gain right at the 30-yard line by Bobby Godinez. Now, they might be in four-down territory here at the 30, or do you try a field goal? I think they're going to bring Schneider on. With the wind at their back, they're going to try a field goal.
They were hoping. You got a bootleg. You can see him pulling now there to protect him in there, but you want to get the ball to him and then get some running room, but that cornerback from San Jose said no chance.
Schneider is 6th nationally, has not missed this year. He's 7 of 7 from beyond 40 yards, 12 of 12 on the year. This will be a 47-yard attempt out of Benico's hold from the right hash mark, and this to extend the minor lead. Snap, kick is on its way. It's high enough, it is plenty long enough, but the kick is no good. He finally missed wide to the right. So Schneider, who had not missed all year long, had plenty of leg, but just off to the right side, and the Spartans dodge a bullet and will take over at their own 30-yard line.
Well, that was a closeout drive right there.
Timeout with 4:32 left third quarter. Miners by 14. Back to San Jose after this message.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Casa Nissan, and we're going long with big savings. Tackle a Titan King Cab for just $19,998. Or go for two in an 05 Ultimate. It's just $18,998. Even better, just for taking a test drive, you'll get 2 tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. The clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Ready for that dream home? Mountain Vista Builders can help make that dream come true. Drop by one of our furnished model homes citywide and see the different floor plans we have to offer. We make homes starting in the mid-60s to over $200,000. Standard features include ceramic tile throughout, alarm system, Whirlpool appliances, landscaping allowance, surround sound pre-wire, and for your peace of mind, a 1-year builder's warranty. Visit Mountain Vista Builders at any of our 6 locations and start living your dream.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Costa Ford, and we're going long with big savings. The Explorer is a first stringer, just $20,800 or $299 a month. And nothing beats the team power of an Eddie Bauer Expedition for just $29,500. And just for taking a test drive, you'll get 2 tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. Hey, the clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Each and every week, your one chance to talk UTEP football directly with head coach Mike Price comes your way on the Mike Price radio program, 7 to 8 each Tuesday from the original Jacksons on El Paso's west side at 4799 North Mason. Invites you to come on by. Personally meet the minor head coach. If you can't be there, our flagship, the Big 600, will carry it along with UTEPathletics.com. Spartans from their own 30-yard line with a first down. They toss it back to Thompson. Coming right, Joe Ward is there to sling him down back at the 26-yard line. The sophomore defensive end, Ward, got there. And evidently, Tim Huntley has made his adjustments, and so far, so good.
That's a toss sweep with the lead back out there, and Ward comes in underneath, and I'm telling you, just smothers him. He had a man on the outside, Howard, but just a great job by Ward.
Second and 14 yards to go. Negative yardage plays. Joe Ward growing up in that minor defense. Thompson the lone setback. Twins left, one receiver right. Rogers at quarterback. Rogers backpedals. The screen left caught by the receiver out there at the 20. And it's James Jones being escorted across the sideline right at the 25-yard line.
Look at this right here, John. He throws that ball out there, and take a look at the pursuit from the UTEP people. Inside, outside, look at it. Set, break down, make a move. Look at it, outside, inside. Beautiful job by those kids.
No gain on the play. It'll be third down from the 26-yard line. Third and 14. Twins to the right, another receiver left. Thompson behind Rogers. And Rogers retreats the throw. As time steps, he's taking a shot up the center of the field. It's overthrown, intercepted. Philip Moss, 40, 45 midfield. Moss at the 40, Moss at the 35, the 30. Moss cuts to the outside. Moss is taken down at the 27-yard line. Philip Moss with his first career interception and the fourth turnover of the day for San Jose State. And the Miners with two more picks today, a 39-yard return for the former quarterback, Philip Moss.
Pulled out an all-out blitz in here. They got close. They put pressure on him. He threw a little bit quick in there. You can see Moss down there, not even close to the receiver. Moss does a nice job of winding his way back down, picking up a blocker right here, cutting to his left, going inside, holding on the ball. Great job by Moss.
Moss with the Miners now with a golden opportunity at the Spartan 27. Palmer changing the play with two receivers to the right, another to the left side. And now whistles and flags stop play. What have we here?
Evidently it's on the...
False start on the offense. Number 17, 5-yard penalty. The down is still one.
That's a receiver, Daniel Robinson, the guilty party.
Usually they go out and ask that judge and say, am I all right? Am I all right right here? And they'll say, yes, you are. Then you've got to hold that second before that snap comes in. And evidently he didn't do it. He flinched.
So first and 15 now. Miners have outgained the Spartans more than 3-1, 3.5-1 in this third quarter. Palmer on first and 15, hands to Marcus Thomas coming left, gets outside, 25-20. Marcus Thomas is all the way to the 16-yard line and has a Miner first down. The Miners freshman from Tucson, his first activity of the day, and the Miners sealed off on the outside left, and Marcus Thomas has 16 yards and a first down.
See number 73 pulling another.
James Riley made a terrific block.
I'm telling you what, he comes down inside. Now, the people of El Paso are going to see a good back in the next 3 years from this kid.
We rode up here with another good one yesterday, yeah. Tyler Ebell, who will be the featured back to start next year. Palmer turns, hands to Thomas, trying to find running room, tried to cut it back, and gets down near the 10-yard line before Dale McNamara got him from behind, but a good gain of almost six. On first down, McNamara on the tackle. It'll be second down at about 4 yards. Patient trying to let his blockers do their job.
Hey, what? You know, you're lucky. It looked to me like he was hit at the line of scrimmage and scratches out 5 yards. That's the type of back you want down there.
Spotted closer to the 11-yard line. It'll be second down and five. 21-7 Miners. 2.5 minutes left, third quarter. Empty backfield, five receivers, three to the right side. Palmer retreats from center, looking left. He throws short that way. It's caught at the 10 at the 5. It's Jason Boyd trying to get to the outside, and he's knocked down inside the 5-yard line. Jason Boyd underneath, and he should have a first and goal for the Miners at about the 4-yard line. Now the tables have turned right here. Again, you've got five wides out there. He just runs and out. Catches it, cuts back inside, misses a tackle right there, and he's got his first down here. This kid's gonna be good too. Played at Oregon State. Hardy on the tackle, first and goal. Double tight end set. Check that tight end to the left, and now we've got whistles and flags, and the Spartans are gonna take a timeout.
That's their first timeout of the second half.
So the Spartans having some problems defensively. Keith Burns decides to burn a timeout here and see if he can't get things righted before the Miners begin to pull away. And again, want to remind you of individual game ticket information. All November home games for the Miners go on sale. Tickets for those games go on sale on Monday at the UTEP Ticket Center, located at the corner of Mesa and Baltimore. And again, the number for UTEP ticket information is 747-5234. Individual men's and women's game basketball tickets on sale Monday at the UTEP Ticket Center. Well, you talk about a shift of momentum. We talked about adjustments. And again, Mike Price and his staff have done a marvelous job making their adjustments here in the third quarter, and their players have responded brilliantly.
Well, they knew they had to come out there, John, had to move that ball on offense. They just couldn't let the defense stay out there that long. And they've done that through possession passes, through a ground game in there, and the defense has come out and answered. Now, Hundley is getting penetration inside, and those guys are squeezing that hole off. And I tell you what, both squads are working on precision right now.
Miners with a first and goal when we resume play at the 4-yard line. Jason Boyd working those underneath zones. Five catches for 46 yards for the junior Miner receiver this afternoon. So many weapons offensively when, again, as we talked about pregame, when the season started, everybody except Jackson and maybe Morrow was largely an unknown.
I'm kind of wondering whether Jackson was just shaken up or...
Well, they probably go with a bigger back down here. Anyhow, first and goal from the 4. Twins to the right, another receiver left. Thomas in the backfield. Palmer's going to throw. Looking left, looking, throws. And it's broken up at the last moment. It's over Francis. Great recovery by Jarrell Hardy.
Absolutely.
Because he rifled it in there, and Francis was open for a moment. Hardy did a great job to break that play up. Look at his reaction.
He runs in there and runs that stop pattern, and Hardy is going on into the end zone because of his momentum, and comes back and knocks it down.
Transfer from Laney Junior College across the bay in Oakland. Second and goal from the 4-yard line. Tight end to the left. Palmer gets to Thomas coming left, and he's cut down at about the 3-yard line. Looks like Mike Lorenzo coming through, a reserve linebacker, or was that Matt Costello? It was Costello again, the freshman from Valley Christian High School here in San Jose. It'll be third down and goal.
That's just a zone handoff in there that pulled the man out again, and San Jose closed it up pretty quickly.
Costello coming from the backside. Miners 3 of 7 on third down, and would like to have the touchdown here. They don't want a field goal, they want 6. Tight end is to the left, 3 receivers to pattern, Thomas to backfield. Here comes a blitz, Palmer to throw, fires right in the end zone, and it's broken up.
Too high.
Intended for Aaron Gibbons, running a little slant pattern, and it'll be fourth down. Field goal unit, no doubt, will be headed onto the field. Not yet.
Just a basic skinny post in here, John, as you'll see up there. Palmer had him, just throw a little bit too high. A little bit hard and a little bit too high.
Right off the hands of Aaron Gibbons in the end zone. So Schneider, who missed a moment ago from 47 yards, this is virtually an extra point. He'll try a 20-yarder. This is an extra point, although it's not from the center of the field, from the left hash mark, out of Bryce Benico's hole. This to extend the Miners' lead to 17 points. With just over a minute left third quarter. Schneider's kick on the way, and the kick is good. So Reagan Schneider nails a 20-yard field goal, and the Miners have added to their lead. with 1:08 left to play in the third quarter. And that was a big kick for Schneider, I'm sure mentally, after missing for the first time this year, to get it right back. 24-7, the Miners are out in front.
I'm sure Mike Price, John, would have loved for those guys to go down there and score a touch in there, but they take it all the way down to the three, kind of a couple of good plays from San Jose, and then a field goal.
Miners, after the turnover, the Moss interception. Philip Moss with his first interception of the year, driving 24 yards for the field goal, eating up 2:20 of what remains of the third quarter. Again, 24 yards, 7 plays, 2:20. Schneider now 13 of 14 this year. Virtually an extra point, a 20-yard field goal, but good for 3, and the Miners up 24-7. Reminder that the Miners are off next week. Back in action 2 weeks from tonight. Big plans to be there. The Rice Owls will be in the Sun Bowl at 7:05. Tickets on sale at the UTEP Ticket Center and at all Ticketmaster outlets, 747-5234 for UTEP ticket information. Now, don't forget, on the radio portion of our simulcast, following the game, our coverage will continue with the locker room report and then Miner Talk at 880-KROD, your opportunity to discuss Miner football and today's game. Here's the pickoff. Schneider, high and short. Fair catch called for. Taken at the 27-yard line by Donald Richardson. So the Miners decided they've seen enough of the long kickoff returns, and they'll kick it high and short to take their chances that way. The Spartans to start inside their own 30.
Now, I know that the Miners want them to make them make a long drive down there and possibly make a mistake the longer they've got the ball going down there, as they did earlier when they put the ball on the ground. But that defense has got to do something, and they've got to do it correctly out there, John, to make sure that they don't get an easy play.
First down at the 28-yard line. Miners showing blitz, now back away. Rodgers with two receivers to the right side. Rodgers turns on the stretch, gives it to Thompson coming left, gets away to Ebach, but Ebach did a great job keeping the outside shoulder and leverage free, and even though he didn't make the tackle, he made the play.
That's his job, you're exactly right. His job is to keep that outside arm and leg free. You can take a look at it here. Then once he does, he can squeeze it or leverage it all the way. You see him grab a little bit, but he's still chasing that ball.
He allowed the pursuit to catch up and make the play.
Absolutely.
And it's a loss. Back to the 24-yard line. It'll be second down, and about 14 yards to go. Two receivers right, another to the left side on second and long. Rodgers again retreats the throw. Up the rush, he's hit as the ball pops in the air. It's loose, it's a fumble. The Spartans fall on it. Jamal Fenner coming on a corner blitz, hit Rodgers from the back side. The ball popped into the air, and the Spartans fall on it back at the 9-yard line. And I guess that's a sack for Jamal Fenner, his second of the afternoon. 15-yard loss on the play.
You got Fenner coming in from this side. You'll see him right there unmolested. And Rodgers goes up. They're lucky that UTEP didn't fall on that ball.
And that is the end of the third quarter. With the score, the Miners 24 and the San Jose State Spartans 7. 15 minutes left from San Jose, back on game day after this.
If a lunar rover can get out of a ditch on the moon, if a tugboat can tow an enormous freighter, if an M1 tank can have a heavy-duty Allison transmission, then why can't your truck? At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Sierra line of pickups. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
The El Paso Times. Real life, real news. Every day we bring you news about your world. The pictures, the stories, the events, and the people who are part of life right here in El Paso. Local news from your community and around the world. Sports, living, business, entertainment, and lots more. For convenient home delivery, call 546-6300 today. The El Paso Times. Real life, real news.
Travis Crawford says move them out now. Travis Crawford, Buick, GMC, Pontiac, Suzuki, Subaru, and Saab announces El Paso's sale of the year. The 04 clearance countdown. For 4 days only, a special factory allocation of 300 new 2004 cars and trucks are priced to move. 4 days and 300 fantastic new cars and trucks. 0% financing on most models. Travis Crawford, Buick, GMC, Pontiac, Suzuki, Subaru, and Saab. Montana at Airway. The 04 clearance countdown. Let's do it now.
If you're looking for the latest news from all of UTEP Athletics, you can watch Miner Sports Weekly, seen four times each week at 10 p.m. Wednesdays, 11:30 p.m. Fridays on KCOS-TV, Channel 13, Cable Channel 12, and 8:30 p.m. it actually is each Wednesday and Friday on Time Warner Cable Channel 7. Third down and 30 for San Jose State at its own 9-yard line.
Big plays from that, that defense in this half.
See what they've got in their playbook here. Draw, screen, yeah. We'll see. Rodgers on the draw, gives it to Thompson. He runs right into Mineo, fumbles the ball. Mineo fighting for it. It's loose in the end zone. It looks like Staples falls on it. Is the safety or a touchdown? It's a touchdown. A touchdown, Miners. Thomas Howard falls on the fumble in the end zone, and the Miners have broken it open here in San Jose.
Tell you what, it was a draw in there, and he comes up, Thompson comes up, Mineo comes in, hits him, drives him back in there. The ball goes down, you can see it to his left. Mineo tries to pick it up, kicked into the end zone. It looks like San Jose, there's Thomas Howard right there.
Jeremy Jones popped it out of there, the hometown boy from Piedmont Hills High School here in San Jose. And now Schneider to try the extra point. Kick is up, and the kick is good, and the Miners have blown it open here in San Jose. 10 seconds into the fourth quarter. Miners with a fumble recovery in the end zone. The defense scores. Mineo makes the play on Thompson, and I guess it was Mineo that popped it loose, although Jeremy Jones was there. And then Thomas Howard falls on it, or picks it up in the back center of the end zone for the score. And the Miners have blown it open here in Northern California.
That defense has come to work in that second half, hasn't it?
Woo. You talk about playing with pride.
Yeah.
You talk about playing with some pride. Fifth San Jose State turnover this afternoon. And again, we talked about the fact Miners had 20 coming into the game, fifth nationally, and five more this afternoon.
Amazing ball club. I'll tell you what, you can see their confidence. They played it close in there, San Jose, and that first half was just dominating. They never panicked. Never panicked. Made adjustments at halftime, and look at 31-7 now.
And to think that San Jose State, down 14-0, scored to close to within 14-7, and they had two golden opportunities in that second quarter to tie or maybe even take the lead. Couldn't do it. And the Miners have blown it open here in this second half. Although still almost the entire fourth quarter to go. It's not over yet. Schneider's kickoff, high, short. And it'll be taken at the 25, the 30. This is Lamont Robinson. And even with a short kickoff, he brings it all the way back to the 40-yard line.
Trying to get a fair catch out of him, but Robinson didn't fair catch. He's a big old kid, and he just got his momentum going forward.
Spartans, one of couple of WAC schools that hadn't lost here at home this year, trying for their third straight home victory for the first time since 1992, but the Miners trying to prevent that from happening, leading it 31-7. Miners 23 WAC road victories, trying for their third in a row this afternoon. High backfield, Rodgers gives it away to Lance Martin, who's got some running room. And Martin's tugged down after a gain of 5 at the 45-yard line. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go. Well, Philip Moss up from the secondary to make the play. Credit Moss playing in place of Demps and Doughty, who obviously went down. Doughty's not played since the first quarter. Philip Moss has done a great job filling in.
Said, well, he's a good athlete, was an ex-quarterback, smart kid.
Right again, lone setback. Is that Martin or Chapman? Anyhow, Rodgers off the bootleg, sidesteps Zach West, scrambling right, now throws back left. It's caught by Wagee, Wagey's got the first down and carries Godwin Akinduro inside the 40 down to the 38-yard line. I think that's Lance Martin, actually, in the backfield. Anyhow, they faked the Martin on the bootleg. Zach West ran right by Rodgers, who skidded to a stop, and then Rodgers throwing back to his left side, finding his tight end Wagey, his first catch of the afternoon. 17 yards and a first down for the Spartans inside the minor 40. Just over a minute gone in this fourth quarter. Miners lead is 24. High backfield behind Rodgers. Man in motion is Broussard. Off the play fake. Deep drop by Rodgers. Plenty of time. Taking a shot to the end zone. He's got a man open. It's overthrown and broken up. Skillern had to wait for the pass, and by that time, both Fenner and Ward had closed on him and were able to break the play up. And it'll be third down. Check that, second down and 10 yards to go. Through three quarters, the Miners 321 yards to 212 for the Spartans.
Just a fake inside in there, tried to hit him deep, and the Miners can't let him do that. He's got Fenner beat, but Ward comes over and helps out. Nice job by Ward. I believe he's an Oakland boy, isn't he?
He's from across the bay, from Hayward High School. Second down and 10 from the 38-yard line. Tight end to the right. And Rodgers on the draw, gives it away. Lamar Ferguson, and he goes down for a loss in the arms of Chris Minio back at the 40-yard line. He loses two on the play. You know, Thompson had 84 yards in the first half. In the third quarter, he had four carries for 9 yards. The Miners have really shut things down.
Done a great job. But Fenner's coming in from the left side again right here. Putting smoke on it. He can see him coming. No place to go. Big guy standing right in. Minio standing right in his face. No place to go. He goes down.
Third and about 12. The Spartans 3 of 12 on third down this afternoon. Rodgers now moves Wagey, the tight end, physically from right to left. Out of the shotgun, Martin to the right of the Spartan quarterback. Snap is back. Rodgers looks for the screen, scrambles right, throws it back, and it's caught at the 35, but well short of the first down by Rufus Skillern, taken down immediately by Calabo and Akinduro, along with Philip Moss, and it'll be fourth down, and Fitzhill probably has no choice but to go for it here.
They have to go, but I tell you what, he catches that ball in there looking for running room.
There was
he didn't even get his head turned halfway around, got hit by two, not one.
It'll be fourth down and 6 yards to go. The Spartans at the minor 35-yard line. Spartans come out with two receivers right, one to the left. San Jose State 2 for 3 on fourth down this afternoon. Shotgun. Snap is back to Rodgers. Looking. Pump fakes. Now he'll tuck it away and run. Now he shovels it off. Caught. Skillern. 20. First down, and he's upended at the 15-yard line. He just kind of shoveled it ahead as he saw Skillern as he was scrambling out to his left. And Skillern's got the first down at the 15-yard line, brought down by Akinduro.
He knew he could not run anybody for that. He pulls it down. He runs. He thinks, well, maybe I've got it. Then you can see him just push it out in front of him. This guy's, what, a fifth-year punter?
Started his career, did Rodgers at Cal Poly. 20 yards on that pass play. First down at the 15-yard line. Tight end to the left. They give it away to Lance Martin. Breaks through the line of scrimmage. Is inside the 10-yard line and tugged down at the 9 by Zach West and Godwin Akinduro. But it's a good gain of about 6, almost 7 yards on first down. It'll be second down and 4. The Spartans at the minor 9-yard line. Good drive by San Jose State.
Straight drive blocking up front in there, but hang on and hang on in there. And who was that, 23?
Pleskoski
that
missed the tackle.
He needs to get their hands up, those feet up under.
Offset backfield on second and 4. Rodgers turns, hands to Martin. He's got a hole. He's got the first down, and he's down to the 1-yard line. It'll be first and goal for San Jose State. This is probably the last thing that Tim Huntley wanted to see here. But the Spartans have put together their first drive of the second half and now are threatening to get on the board.
Got to get, when those backs get into that secondary, John, they're having problems tackling them. They got to get up underneath them and drive through them.
First and goal at the 1. Tight ends bookend the line. Offset backfield. Rodgers under center. Turns, gets to Martin, and he's hit and dropped. Justin Honnell And Chris Minio, the two tackles just squeezed Lance Martin. There was no room for Martin. He loses a yard on the play.
He tries the right side over there, and I tell you what, Honnell comes in there, and bam, you can see both Minio and Honnell.
Honnell got him low, Minio got him high. He loses 2 yards on the play. It'll be second and goal from the 3-yard line. 10th play of the drive coming up.
Minio's having a heck of a ball game out there.
Particularly in his second half.
Yeah.
Second and goal. Thompson now returns. He's the deep back behind the I back. Callier, the up back. Second and goal from the 3. They come right on the option. Rogers cuts it upfield, and he will score. Dale Rogers crosses the goal line. First time we've seen option this afternoon, and Rogers, who appears to be shaken up, does score on a 3-yard run.
He's got a speed option coming out there, and they drive him deep. He cuts back inside, but Rodriguez told the official
he got dragged
the
down.
Linesman. No, he told the official that somebody moved in there prior to that, and the official wouldn't listen to him. Who's that, Ward?
Yeah, Adrian Ward is down. The way they're working on that right ankle and leg, it looks like it might be a cramp. Anyhow, Ward is the man that's down. Anytime they put pressure downwards on that leg, you suspect a cramp. And then now that you see they're rubbing the back of his calf, so apparently it is only a cramp, and that's certainly good news. Spartans down by 18 here. Would you go for two at this particular time? I think they are going to go for two.
Well, you need as many points as you can get on the scoreboard, and you've only got 10 minutes left.
Adrian Ward having some problems getting off the field. There's Adrian. Don't see any problems there, but he's cramping up such that he can't put very much pressure on. Now he's walking better as he gets toward the sideline, so we think he'll be okay. Anyhow, Spartans are going to go for two. Now this would pull them to within 16, which would be 2 touchdowns and 2 extra point conversions.
Big play in that drives when Rogers went out on that 4th and 6 and just shoveled that ball to get the first down.
So they'll put it in the middle of the field from the 3-yard line. Now they hustle to the line of scrimmage. Rogers rolling to his right, now trying to throw back. Alex Obamese knocks him down. Obamese says, "You think no you chance. Fooled me?
No chance, big guy. You're going down."
10:04 left, 4th quarter. Miners 31, Spartans 13. Game day will continue after these words from San Jose.
Tony here, better known as a warehouse guy at Appliance World. It's a busy man's job here to keep all brands and appliances always in stock. It's not easy. Here's another truckload. They don't last here in the showroom. Not at these prices. Get a package, and you'll save even more. You want to know where I bought my big screen TV? At Appliance World. You buy it somewhere else, you'll pay too much. So come by Appliance World at I-10 East and exit Lee Trevino.
Great deals and a huge selection. We've got it all at Sunland Park Pontiac Buick GMC. The 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix GT1 leads the pack in power, handling, and affordability. Only $245 a month. Or test drive the 2004 GMC Yukon XL, rated by J.D. Powers as the most dependable full-size SUV, only $467 a month.
Great service, great prices, great selection. At Sunland Park, Pontiac Buick GMC.
Sure, we love the beautiful Southwest, but sometimes you need an escape. That's when you call Sun Travel, El Paso's premier travel agency. Sun Travel has been helping their valued clients plan their business and vacation travel for over 38 years.
Sun Travel can help find the perfect vacation value for everyone with personal service you won't find on the web. You deserve the expertise that Sun Travel can provide.
Sun Travel, with 2 locations to serve you.
You can relive all the highlights of today's game and of every minor game, home and away, on Coach Mike Price television show, seen each Tuesday at 7, Tuesday and Wednesday at 7 on Time Warner cable channel 7, and we tape live each Tuesday at noon at Frankie's Sports Grill inside Fiesta Lanes on El Paso's west side. Why not come by this Tuesday and have lunch with us? You can order either off the menu or sample the delicious buffet. That's the Mike Price Television Show, 7 p.m. Tuesdays and Wednesdays. We tape Tuesdays at noon at Frankie's Sports Grill inside Fiesta Lanes on El Paso's west side.
I moved that front lane up, line up there, John, and watch for an onside kick.
And here is the kickoff. They kick away. This will be brought back. Jackson from the 3. 10. Cuts it back. 20. He's gone. 30. 35. 40. 40 midfield. Jackson cuts it again at the 40. He's at the 30. Jackson at the 25. He's out of bounds inside the 20-yard line. Howard Jackson, how does he do it? No flags down, and the Miners start the possession in the red zone. 77-yard kickoff return.
I'm telling you what, this little kid, he's got a blocker in front of him, comes up, hits that seam, and that's all you need. See him turn on that second gear, breaks out. The kicker does a decent job, otherwise he'd been gone. Breaks back out. Got another guy hitting him, 160 pounds. Another guy hitting him. Another guy hitting
Jackson
him.
Jackson has just passed a youngster you know well. Ray Holt has become the second best kick returner in UTEP history behind Cedric Johnson. First down at the 19-yard line. Palmer hands to Marcus Thomas. Stumbles, stays on his feet, gets inside the 15 and down to the 14-yard line for a gain of 5 before he was tripped up by Anthony Flores. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go. Howard Jackson, did you know, coming into the game, was third among active players in college football in kickoff return yardage. Third among active players.
He's had a phenomenal career here, I'll tell you that.
Call it a gain of 4 to the 15-yard line. It'll be second down and 6. 3 receivers in the pattern. Shotgun, Thomas to the right of Palmer. Inside, 10 minutes left. Here's the screen left. It's caught in the middle by Jason Boyd, and it's incomplete. He was hit, and the ball came out.
Perfect call, perfect call. Slip screen inside. I'm telling you what, he had a full blitz in there. All he had to do, catch it, and he's in the end zone.
But Boyd couldn't catch it.
Wow.
Bobby Godinez was there to cover on the play. It'll be third down. Miners don't want a field goal. They want a touchdown here from the 15-yard line, 3rd and 6. Miners did have the right call for the blitz, but couldn't pull it off. Francis and Boyd to the right side. To the left side is Higgins. Jackson is the deep back. Palmer under center. Spartan showing blitz, and here they come. Palmer to throw. Fires into the right flat, too far out in front of Chris Francis, and it'll be fourth down. So they didn't want a field goal, but they're going to try one, and it'll be about a 32-yard attempt for Reagan Schneider.
John, how many times has Palmer been on his back today from the rush?
I don't think he's been sacked even once, has he?
I'm telling you, great job. You're talking about a 7-8-man blitz coming in there, and they're picking it up.
Ficklin was pressuring Palmer. Schneider, who hit one from 20 yards a moment ago, 32 yards now from the left hash mark. And just to give the Miners their lead of 18 back once again. And it's a fake. Benico's rolling right, dumps it off. Austin at the 15, the 10. First down and goal to go at the 5-yard line. There's a great place and a great time for everything.
That's right.
That was it for the fake field goal.
They've been working on that the past couple weeks, but if Benico's looked down in the end zone, I'm telling you what, there was a receiver down there, and I don't know who it was. It was wide open.
Benico's a former high school quarterback and baseball pitcher. All he had to do was make sure that he floated it out there to Matt Austin. Eric Wilson saved a touchdown. First and goal at the 5-yard line. Two receivers left, one to the right side. Jackson in the backfield. Palmer turns, gives to Jackson, right side at the 5, stretches out, gets down to the 1-yard line, and down goes the umpire hard. Watch the great block Josh Chamois makes here, Bernie. Peeling back on Tony Ficklin. Wow!
Tell you what, Ficklin, there's a tough kid right there. What's he had? 12 tackles for loss and 5 sacks? So he's pretty active. Chamois popped him.
Second and goal. The ball spotted between the 1 and the 2-yard line. Miners go with it. tandem in the backfield. It's Smith and Chamois, wing left, and now they jump offside. Benji Graniello, the right guard, anticipating the snap count. Graniello, the senior, punches himself in the helmet. That'll cost the Miners five.
Prior to the snap, false start. 52 on the offense, 5 yards down the stilton.
Boy, you know Benji's embarrassed, don't you? It'll be second and goal now across the 6 yard line.
These kids have been so well disciplined, and Lawrence Livingston is a guy to attribute that to. But now they got to bring in their receivers, take out the heavy stuff, and probably go for a pass in the end zone.
Just over 8 minutes left, fourth quarter. Miners looking for a touchdown here. Second and goal from the six. Twins to each side. Marcus Thomas is the setback. Shotgun formation. Snap is back to Palmer. Fakes to Thomas. Comes right at the five. He dives. He's into the end zone. Jordan Palmer. Touchdown, Miners. Concussion or no, early this year, Palmer goes airborne. He got hit hard, but bounces on the turf and right up into the air, and the Miners have added to their lead here in San Jose.
You got a fake inside and a counteraction coming back out. Do you think he wants it? Look at that big kid up in the air, 235 pounds.
Wow. And I know somewhere older brother Carson, the Cincinnati Bengals quarterback, is beaming proudly. The snap kick is on its way by Reagan Schneider, and the kick is good. And the Miners have extended their lead. 7:46 left, fourth quarter. 38-13 Miners as we continue on game day from San Jose.
It's the fourth quarter countdown at Casa Nissan, and we're going long with big savings. Tackle a Titan King Cab for just $19,998. Or go for two in an 05 Ultimate. It's just $18,998. Even better, just for taking a test drive, you'll get two tickets to see the Miners at their next home game. The clock's running, so hurry in for the fourth quarter countdown today.
Gentlemen, it's true. NBA League Pass can get you up to 40 games per week. Elton, can I watch the Clippers play if I live in Kalamazoo?
With NBA League Pass, you can.
Ron, what's the League Pass motto?
Come on, Artest, you know this.
Closing is the key to success, and never forget it, guys.
Call now to order NBA League Pass for just $169. When it comes to sports, we're on your team.
Stupid, stupid, stupid.
For worry-free air conditioning and heating, Gray Air Conditioning has been serving the El Paso and Las Cruces area with professional service and installation for over 25 years. Gray Air Conditioning offers 24-hour service and emergency service 7 days a week. Certified technicians provide maintenance and installation on all makes and models, such as Mastercool, Trane, and Lennox. Call the professionals for a free estimate at 544-1566.
You can hear all UTEP home games, home and away, on the Miners Radio Network and flagship station, the Big 600, KROD in El Paso, along with KBY, Good Time Oldies, AM 1360, and Ruidoso, New Mexico, and of course, via the Miners broadcast package by subscription at the Miners official athletic website, utepathletics.com. Jordan Palmer's first rushing touchdown of the year, and he certainly earned it.
Oh, I mean, airborne. A la John Elway in that one Super Bowl game. I mean, went up in the air, got turned a somersault, and still scored.
Schneider, a high short kickoff again. And again, it's Lamont Robinson at the 25, looking for running room to the 30. Tripped up Jake Sears, who's now a tight end, but was a high school linebacker. Jake Sears got upfield to make the play.
Just a big counter fake coming out around. He knew he was going to run that ball. He sees that end zone at about the 3. Goes up in the air, does a scissors, and goes in for a touchdown. I'm telling you what, the kid's tough.
For the Miners, 19 yards following the fake in 6 plays, 2 minutes, 23 seconds. Palmer, a 6-yard touchdown run, his first touchdown of the year. First down from the 30-yard line. Rodgers at quarterback. He's gone the distance. Rodgers retreats to throw. Under a rush, scrambles to his right side. Being tugged down, Alex Obamese again. Alex Obamese with a loss back to the 29-yard line. Alex Obamese, the sophomore from Houston, has had a big second half.
Tell you what, Rogers looks and looks and looks. The secondary's got everybody covered down there. He said, well, I got to bail. I got to get out of here. But Obamese grabs that shirt and wheels him around, throws him to the ground.
We'll call it no gain. Obamese says, not on my watch. Second down and 10 from the 30-yard line. Miners having some fun here in the second half in San Jose. Second down and 10 yards to go. Rogers fades, looking to throw. Good time. He's taking a shot up the center of the field. Broussard, and he can't get it inside the 30-yard line. He had a stride on Cedric Click, and it was pretty well thrown, but just a little too long. It'll be third down and 10 yards to go.
That's the second time they've ran a deep middle pass in there, and they've got two receivers, John, going to the same direction in there, which, of course, is going to take two defenders in there. If he'd have thrown that a little shorter, he probably would have got it, but you don't want two defenders in there, so either one can pick it off.
Broussard, whose brother Jamal was an outstanding two-year performer here at San Jose State, is probably the fastest of the Spartans receivers and is now with the Cincinnati Bengals, where he, of course, is Carson Palmer's teammate. Small world, isn't it? You bet. Twins to each side on third and 10. Out of the shotgun. Snap is back to Rodgers. Miners are blitzing. He steps up, fires left, and is short of Rufus Skillern trying to come back for it at the 40-yard line. It'll be fourth down. And Fitzhill says not so quickly to his punting unit, and apparently now we'll send them on the field. So it'll be fourth down. The defense is held, and the Miners will get their hands on the ball again with 6:49 left in the fourth quarter, trying for their fifth straight victory, their third in a row on the road.
I'll guarantee you they're going to be in a punt safe this time, John, making sure that that punt's not fake. We're going to have linebackers bailing out of there.
Fenner drops to his own 35-yard line. Prather standing at his own 15. Mike Pettis slightly off the line of scrimmage. And here comes Prather's kick. Chamba almost got it and then runs into it. That's probably going to be a five-yard variety. Fenner's got it, but it won't matter. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line. Second time the Miners have run into the punter today. This should not be a personal foul, though. Oh, that's a shame. They're calling that a 15-yard penalty. That's a shame. Didn't look like it to me, Bernie.
Well, he goes down, he acts, and there he is right there. Probably pulled into him, but in this situation right there, don't
get
put yourself in that situation. No.
That's a mistake
by
Chamois.
You don't need that.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker. Number 27 on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
Well, that is something no doubt Coach Price will talk about following the game. Not once, but twice today. The Miners have run into the punter. And in this both situations, it was fourth and long.
Yeah, you
get your hands back on the ball. You don't need to block the punt. What you want to do is take the ball away from them. It's just not thinking.
And the field position was going to be good, too.
Right.
You know, so that's Trafar. What's his name? His back
Adam Tafralis. Adam Tafralis, a redshirt freshman from San Mateo, who actually is in his third year here at San Jose State. He gray-shirted his first year. In other words, he was attending school but not practicing with the team. And not a full-time student, probably, either. Tafralis is the quarterback. Began the year as the starter. Tafralis, short drop, looking right, throws, and a catch by Skillern. And now he breaks away, gives ground, still on his feet, and will be taken down at about the 38-yard line. That's 17 yards on the play. Tafralis hits his first one to Rufus Skillern.
Tafralis goes back, takes a look over the middle in here, and he runs a post pattern. He hits him right there a little bit high, but nice catch.
Tafralis to Skillern on his first completion. And a first down for the Spartans with under 6.5 minutes left in this fourth quarter. Wing left set. And Collier comes in motion right. Tafralis rolling to his right, looking, fires into the flat. Skillern again, breaks away from J.D. Hearn. 30 and out of bounds on the near sideline, close to another first down. J.D. Hearn trying to make a play, and he just kind of slipped on that soft turf here at Spartan Stadium. Jeremy Jones escorted Skillern out of bounds, close to another Spartans first down. And it is a first down for San Jose State.
Just You talk about mistakes, John. I'm sure Coach Price is going to address this later on in the first of the week, but you just cannot have two roughing the punter.
There's no advantage by blocking the right punt there. I mean, you're up handily. Just get your hands back on the ball and run clock. High backfield. They give it away to Martin coming left. He spins and goes down in the arms of Robert Rodriguez at the 26-yard line after the gain of a couple. It'll be second down, about 8 yards to go. Jeremy Jones was also there. We can see Mark Dowdy now, Bernie, for the first time across the way. He is standing with his arms folded without his shoulder pads. So whatever the injury was, obviously took him out of the game. That's the first time we've seen him down on the minor sideline across the way. What a tough break for Dowdy. He just gets back into the lineup, and he's hurt again.
Early in the ball game also.
Offset backfield. On second down, Dallas comes left on the option. Chris Minio's got him. Minio brings it down, but he got a piece of the face mask. Minio got him, but he got a piece of the face mask. And we'll see if it's a 5 or a 15-yarder. Again, it's a personal foul.
Let me tell you something. Whoever's blocking Minio, matter of fact, he got grabbed by the face mask prior. But that's a good call by the official.
Yeah, Minio, they did. 77.
Had him by the face mask.
That's right, which would be Armando Amadeo Novella. Miners have been heavily penalized today.
Personal foul. Face mask. Number 70 on the defense. Half the distance to goal, first down.
Spartans have hardly been touched today. So it'll be first down at the 13-yard line for San Jose State with 5:23 left fourth quarter. Miners up 38-13. Martin is the lone back. Tight end is to the right. Three receivers in the pattern. And now Trafalas looks back to the sideline. Trafalas barking him out. Snap is back. Gives it away to Martin, who cuts it back. Martin looks hammered down by Jeremy Jones on the top and Robert Rodriguez on the bottom down near the 10-yard line. That's a tough 3 yards for Lance Martin. It'll be second down and 7 at the 10.
That is what I'm talking about, John. You get that back, that handoff to the left. He cuts back inside. Somebody's got to fill that gap. There's Jeremy Jones. 3 yard gain.
Second down and 7 from the 10. I formation in the backfield. Spartans go with a double tight end look. Trafalas off the play fake. Bootleg right. He got the corner. He's going to try at the 10. And Adrian Ward takes him down at the 5-yard line, about a yard shy of the first down. And it'll be third down coming up. Next time the Spartans snap the ball, less than 4 minutes will remain in today's game.
Well. Tell you what, that's what it's all about down there. You get those sounds of pads and helmets clicking in there. Mm.
San Jose State just now at 300 yards on the afternoon. Third down and a yard to go from the 5-yard line. No doubt in 4-down territory. They come right on the option. Defala spins. Does he get in? He's close. And apparently he's cut down just shy of the goal line. As they unpile, it'll stop the clock momentarily, but I think they got him just short of the goal line. But it is a first and goal for the Spartans. He hadn't seen option until the third quarter. Now we've seen it a couple of times here in the fourth quarter of play. So it'll be first and goal just short of the goal line for San Jose State. 3.5 minutes approaching left in the football game.
Miners got their big beef in there. It's close to that goal line down there, and they want to make sure that they're not going to get pushed off that ball.
They stopped the clock momentarily. Now it ought to be running again. Well, they've not started it, and that's wrong. Rich Colon did not restart the clock, and that is absolutely incorrect as Trafalas leaps over the top and has a San Jose State touchdown. Shame on Rich Colon. He never restarted the clock.
Down to 3:24.
That should have been less than 3:20, maybe 3:15, but Colon never restarted the clock. So Trafalas scores on a quarterback keeper, and the Spartans have added to their total on a 1-yard touchdown run by Trafalas.
That's an unnecessary touchdown, John, on that. You just can't rough that punter like that.
It's twice the Miners have done it today. Here's Jeff Carr to try the extra point. Kick is up, and the kick is good. So San Jose State back with 18 after an 81-yard drive. 38-20 with 3:24 left fourth quarter. Finish coming up from San Jose. Stay with us after these words.
Which high-definition big screen is right for you? CRT, DLP, flat panel, or LCD? It can be confusing, but at Pat Goff Appliance TV Warehouse, our personalized red carpet service make buying a new Toshiba high-definition big screen easy. Plus, on all Toshiba high-definition big screens, including the exclusive cinema series, you pay nothing till 2006. Pat Goff Appliance TV Warehouse in Las Cruces and in El Paso, where we'll deliver your new Toshiba high-definition big screen in 5 hours, guaranteed.
How about some jeans?
Get them on, Cowtown Boots, get them on.
How about some boots? Like our black bullhide western boot, only $49.95. And our newest boot, all leather alligator prints, only $99.99.
Cowtown Boots, get them on.
Fox Toyota is backing the UTEP team with a season-long tailgate party. Boy, Fox Toyota is opening huge holes in truck and SUV prices. You'll score with big rebates and discounts because we're passing all the savings on to you. Save $6,000 on Tundras, $4,000 on 4Runners, $3,000 on Highlanders, and $3,000 on Tacomas. Catch the year's best deal now at El Paso's number one, Boy, Fox Toyota.
Before we resume play, let us pause 10 seconds for station identification from Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. This is the UTEP Miners Football Network. Miners up by 18 with 3:24 left to play in the fourth quarter. The Spartans with a lengthy drive of 81 yards to Fralis, scoring his first rushing touchdown of the year. Again, he began the year as the starter at quarterback. He started the Stanford game and then the Rice game when the Spartans fell behind 34-7. It was Rogers, when Rogers entered that game, that the Spartans came back and ultimately won.
Yeah, I think Trefellis had was completed about 26% of his passes. Got the Hans team in here waiting for the onside kick.
It's coming to the left side. Jeff Carr to the honors, and a big, big bounce. It'll be handled by Philip Moss. Phillip's had a huge day.
Yeah.
Huge day with his first interception, filling in for Demps and Dowdy, who are both out. And Philip Moss handling the big hop. 70 yards. We've got 81 yards. 12 plays, 4 minutes, 22 seconds to Fralis with a 1-yard touchdown run, his first of the season. And here come the Miners. Come back to work.
A couple of first downs. It's all over, John.
Palmer with Howard Jackson behind him. Jordan turns, gives it away to Howard Jackson, and there's nothing there. There's Staples, who's been very quiet today. And Staples, along with Kinji Green, whose name we haven't called out much either, with the initial hit. Loss of a couple on the play. It'll be second down and 12 yards to go.
San Jose has still
two timeouts.
Yeah, they're going to have to think about doing something here pretty quick.
Second down and 12. Miners with 3 minutes left to go, watching it run. Robinson and Gibbons both come out to the left side. Palmer under center. Jordan turns, gives to Jackson again, right side. Short yardage. Howard inside the 46-yard line. Gains about three. And it'll be third down coming up. Now they're going to spend the timeout.
Have to.
So that'll leave them with one.
Now they're just trying to keep that ball. Jackson slips coming out of there. Tries to find himself a hole, but they squeeze him down pretty good. He goes down. Then San Jose calls the timeout,
leaving them with one. Eric Wilson on that last tackle for the Spartans. Don't forget, Miners off next week, but 2 weeks from tonight, Rice comes to the Sun Bowl at 7:05. Get your tickets at the UTEP Ticket Center and all Ticketmaster outlets. And all games at home This football and basketball season can be heard in Spanish on La Consentida, KSVE 1150 on your AM dial in El Paso with Omar Ropelli and Rick Bolaños. Home games in Spanish on La Consentida in El Paso. Mike Price sees his Miners 2 minutes and 35 seconds away from going 6-2, assuring themselves a winning season and bowl eligibility. We were incorrect last week when we stated they needed two more victories. They needed only one, because once every 4 years, you can count a 1AA towards your bowl eligibility. Miners haven't used it forever. Didn't need it in 2000. So if they need it this year, it's there. Third down and long. Palmer will go up top. Dumps it over the middle. It's caught by Cox. He's got the first down and more. He's all the way to the 30-yard line. First catch of the day, I do believe, for Jonas Kratz. The Miners senior tight end, his second catch of the afternoon. And the Miners now, with 2:28 left, have four more downs to work with at the Spartan 30. Godinez and Powell in on the tackle.
Tell you what, they're not afraid. They come in there, back him up. Three-step drop, Pitcraft's coming across, made a nice grab, got his first down. Just about do it, John.
24 yards on that pass play. 38-20. Miners come to the line of scrimmage. Robinson and Givens out to the right side. Francis to the left side. Jackson behind Palmer. Gordon turns, gives it away to Jack, or rather, Marcus Thomas, 30, 25, breaking tackles. Marcus Thomas still on his feet, inside the 21-yard line, is close to another first down. Marcus Thomas stumbled coming out of there. Finally, Larry Collins was able to bring him down, but good hard running by the freshman from Tucson, Marcus Thomas.
He hadn't seen much playing time, but I tell you, you can always count on that kid. He's tough. He's about 195 pounds, John?
And when he gets in the weight room, no telling.
Yeah, he's going to be
kind of a beast he could be.
He's going to be a four.
Really enjoyed riding up here with Tyler Ebell yesterday. We had a
nice
chance to visit with him. Great kid. And he's really happy to be a Miner and likes playing for Mike Price. Look forward to watching him next year. He'll be wearing Thomas number two. Marcus already knows that, too. That's Ebell's number. Second down and about a yard to go. Just over a minute left to go. Miners have got this one won. Palmer gives to Thomas, and Thomas surges inside the 20. He's got the first down. That looks like a rugby scrum.
Eight people on it.
Maybe your son Nick is somewhere in the middle of that thing. And now we've got a late flag down, evidently a personal foul, either one way or both ways. 55 seconds left to play in the game. And maybe a frustration penalty here. Rich Colin will let us know.
Well, must be
Miners are going to be able to take the knee regardless. Oh, one of the Miners headbutted one of the Spartans.
Dead ball, personal foul. 68 on the offense, 15 yards, and the down will be one.
Luis Espinoza. It's not what the Miner coaching staff is looking for. Luis Espinoza, who is a junior and the younger brother of Robert Espinoza. Look at Mike Price. You think he's hot? Wow.
Well, that's a lack of discipline, John.
Sure
he
is.
Doesn't like to see that. I mean, he's very comfortable with what he's told his kids about discipline.
And Rich Colin steps into the Miner huddle and says, gentlemen, let's just get this
Absolutely.
Thing over with. Let's just get this thing over with. It is a first down, a dead ball foul from the 34-yard line. And now, the prettiest play in football. Miners will have to do it maybe twice. Is that Duarte or is that not? It's Palmer. Palmer takes one knee. Here comes Espinoza back into the game. And if they get the football ready for play in the next couple of seconds, which they may not, that's going to do it. Nope, don't have to run another play. That's going to be it. Miners don't have to run another play. They have come to Northern California and have their fifth straight victory. Will go 6-2 and 4-1 in Western Athletic Conference play. Miners got out quickly today. They are bowl eligible. They've guaranteed themselves a winning season as the final seconds tick down. Congratulations to Coach Mike Price and the UTEP Miners. She's all over from San Jose, and the Miners have won it this afternoon. A solid effort by UTEP as Mike Price and Dr. Fitzhill, Keith Burns shaking hands. Old Pac-10 rivals, Price and Burns, who is a coordinator at the University of Southern California. And there's Fitzhill. Jordan Palmer, what another tremendous effort for him this afternoon. The sophomore quarterback guiding the Miners to victory. Miners taking care of business in Northern California in a big way this afternoon. 38-20 is the final. The Miners over the San Jose State Spartans, and a hug between father and son, Aaron Price, the Miners quarterback's coach, with a hug for Papa. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back on television with some final words. 38-20, the Miners over the Spartans. We'll wrap it up in a moment from San Jose.